time to rate some custom Magic the Gathering cards. We're going to start off with the Power Creeper. It's a green one, generic 2/2. And what else does it got? It's a grizzly bear. But Power Creeper gets +1/+1 for each year from 2022 to now. So what is it, 2024? So now for 2 mana, we get a 4/4 creature. I can feel its growth. Slowly but surely, one day the world won't tolerate its existence. I think it's probably going to be fair for like at least 10 years. And then at some point, maybe it doesn't even matter. Maybe 2 mana creatures with no other text than power and toughness don't even have any playability in this world. Anyway, I'm going to actually say this is a good card. Even though it's a little weird and janky. Now remember, if you want to submit your cards, you got to be part of my Discord in the description, because I hate the search feature on Reddit. So let's look at one more from Nuh-uh, Yeah-huh. So the Nuh-uh is blue 3 generic instant, counter target spell, Nuh-uh. Counter the next spell cast by the spell's controller. Okay, that sounds very unfair. It's like, I'm countering this spell. By the way, the next thing you play, it's also countered! Get it out of here! Yeah-huh. White 3 generic instant. This spell can't be countered. The next spell you cast can't be countered. It's like a silence almost. It's actually, the first half I think is a bit unfair. But the second half is very fair. 4 mana to try to like get through counter spells. That sounds like it's fine. But like, what is even the point of that? When the next spell you cast can't be countered, this is redundant, right? Because if you have 4 mana up, wouldn't you just play Nuh-uh? Like, if you're going to play 2 spells a turn, just play Nuh-uh. It's actually more powerful because you get to counter the counter spell, but also you get to counter the next spell that they play at the same time. So actually, I think this is a bit of a design flaw. Would not actually work. Okay, next up. Okay, let's look at some super chats. If it's like, okay, this looks like a big one. So I'm going to save the big ones. I'm going to save the big cycles for the second half of the show. Right, this is the third, fourth. So we're going to start off with One Frame James. Thank you very much for your super chat. I hope this is all on Discord. Parallel Shadow. It is! You know how to use the feature. Excellent. I'm a huge fan of One Frame James. We got a black 13/13 avatar. Looks like this is going to have something. It's going to have very Death Shadow-esque, I suspect. Very Death Shadow-esque. A game can't begin with any cards named Parallel Shadow in a player's main deck. Huh? A game can't begin with any cards named. So it can't be in the deck, but it can be in the sideboard. Parallel Shadow gets -X/-X, where X is the number of non-basic lands you control. I don't even know how this works. Okay, a game can't begin with any cards named Parallel Shadow in a player's main deck, but that includes you! And it gets -X for each for the number of non-basic lands you control. So this is enormous. I really don't know how you conjure this thing into existence. It wasn't from this world. It wasn't even from the plane of existence. I think it's more flavorful than good. I don't know how it's fair. It's fair. I would never play it. Of course. I can't figure this Discord thing out. I'm old. It's pretty straightforward, to be honest. You gotta look up Discord. All right, next freebie, section one. We got the Real Paradox Engine. It's a 4-mana legendary artifact. Non-land artifacts lose all abilities. So artifacts that are not lands. Why can't we screw over the lands too? What, is that not a, is that a problem or something? I don't think that's a problem. I think we should get rid of all the artifact lands. I think we should, all artifact lands should be legal and we are allowed to punish them. Either way, it will be an enormous disappointment at this year's Inventions Fair. That's right! I love the card. Actually, I think this is a banger. We need more cards that shut off all the artifact. We don't have enough artifact hate out there, in my opinion. Just not enough artifact hate. We need more hate for them artifacts. Bacon, Kappa, thank you very much for the super chat. We're gonna look up Ignis. Just gonna look up Ignis. Hopefully that's good enough. It was good enough! Ah, oh, the system is working perfectly. This Discord system's working perfectly. Ignis Pachydermata. It's a red, 2 generic 3/3 elven horror. When Ignis Pachydermata, whatever, enters the battlefield, it's not a token. You create a token that's a copy of it, except it's a 1-1. Pay red, Ignis. The hardest part of this card is pronouncing it. Pachydermata gets +1/+0 until end of turn. If this is the third time this ability has resolved this turn, Ignis, the Ignis creature, fights target creature you don't control. Got big enough and all of a sudden decided to start a fight with somebody. It's actually a perfectly fine card. So it enters about, if it's not a token, create a token. So you get a copy, but it's a 1-1. So it's got like a little buddy to bully other people around here. That's the way I look. That's the way I'm looking at this thing. Okay, next up we go to the freebie section with the Cursed Librarian. Okay. I guess you're cursed to stay in the library for forever. We got a black one generic. 1/2 Vampire Warlock. Sagas you cast cost 2 less to cast. Oh, you must be well read! But cost an additional 4 life to cast. Oh, God! So, I guess this is fine? I mean, that's a lot of life to spend on your sagas. Even for Commander, for one-on-one, this is a disaster. Those who don't learn from history are doomed to repeat it. Those who are doomed in other ways. Yeah, sometimes ignorance is bliss. In this case, this person knows too much. It hurts. They know so much it hurts. Benjamin says, it's an artifact, Nikachu, so it loses loses its ability because its own ability, so it doesn't lose its. That's why that's the real paradox engine, or is that? Oh! Did not even catch that. The real paradox engine says non-land artifacts lose all abilities, but it also is an artifact. So does it lose its ability at all, or does it stay? Does it remain? Life is complicated. It gets even more complicated with the real paradox engine. Next super chat. Let's take a look at Gabrielle. Hey, Nikachu, mine is the True Spark. True Spark it is. The one spark to rule them all. Uh-oh. You didn't hear that you have to submit during Discord now. I guess I have to look for you on Reddit. Please use my Discord, Gabrielle, please. Okay, hold on. True Spark. Found it easily, at least. The True Spark is a very colorful card. It is a 5 mana sorcery. It deals 2 damage to any target. It also has Pinnacle. If exactly Wooburg is spent to pay to cast the spell, True Spark deals 5 damage to target player and all creatures. Oh God. Planeswalkers and battles they control, and you gain 5 life. You only gain 5 life for all that damage. That's amazing. This is a very, very colorful, the colorful blast. Orthodox spellcasting anyone can use. Yet only a true master will bring it to its full potential. Isn't this like OP? It's like just a 5 mana, huge, massive board wipe. Okay. Deals 5 damage to target player, all creatures, planeswalkers. I guess it's okay. There's worse things out there. I'm used to, it's still a 5 mana huge, it's like a 5 mana board wipe, alright? And it just shoots somebody for like 5 more damage. Okay, next up, let's go back to the freebie section. Freebie section, the Landlord. I like the sound of that one. Okay, it's a land, it taps for a colorless. And other lands you control get +1/+1. That is weird. Okay, it is literally the Landlord. Yeah, it's a land. It's not the person that collects your rent every month. It is the Lord of the Land. So gonna buff up that treetop village and that fairy conclave amongst the and Mutavault and Misha's factory. The Lord of the Land. Okay, I give it a pass. I also think it's very cute. Brawly Shadow, how much for a group of 10 cards? Well, the going rate right now is like $10, it seems. You guys are going to make me raise the price, I swear. People like Majra and Bacon Catbug. So long as the show is like still like under 2 hours, I think we're going to be okay. But thank you very much for the super chat. So we're going to donate that one to the freebie section. So it's basically like $2 a card at the moment. Skyfire, we have a red, blue, white, 3 generic. Sorcery with Convoke. Destroy all creatures without flying. I'm surprised there's not more cards like this. where you blow up all the creatures without flying. Like, why does flying always have to kill... Why does everything kill everything with flying? Like, if there's a big flood, that should not destroy the flying creatures. They're immune to flood. What else? There's apparently, like, a series here. Folk destroy all creatures without flying. Oh, no, this is basically the same thing. Skyfire. Without... I think this was... Skyfire. No, they're both the same card. Okay, moving on. We got the, We have Cog Lazalek, the next step. I bet this person is somehow related to Kozilek. Oh, it is! It is an Eldrazi ape beast of some sort. This is truly amazing. When you cast Cog Lazalek, create 4 banana tokens and draw a card. Very cute. It's got Devoid, so it's a colorless card. And it's got Banana Later, too. When this creature attacks, defending player sacrifices 2 permanents. They should sack 2 bananas. If they can't, they lose the game. Defending player sacks 2 permanents. Then you and the defending player create 2 colorless artifact tokens named Banana. With sack this artifact, add green to your mana pool, and you gain 2 life. Oh, that's great. It's like you made food. And it casts, and it's for a low, low cost of 11 generic mana, a green and a colorless for this 10-10 ape beast token. I think it's fair. I've seen worse. Frankly, the regular Eldrazi are way, way, way more complicated. Yeah. Banana Later! I would love to make this my thumbnail. Banana Later. That'll be fantastic. Slightly fair or not. Yeah, instead of getting nothing, you at least get some tokens. They're gonna pad your life total. Also get some tokens to get some of that mana back that you sacrificed. Okay, next super chat will go to Nick Wierick. Assess the threat. Thank you very much for your super chat. Like assessing the threat at the table. Do people not read? Submit cards via Discord. Check description. I'm doing this so I can save time. Because when Reddit doesn't work, it really, really doesn't work. And it really sucks. Don't worry, my Discord is more lenient than custom magic, that's for sure. Okay, we got Assess the Threat, which is a blue-blue-red-red enchantment. As Assess the Threat enters the battlefield, each player calls out the name of a player at the table. I choose you. Like that. It's not name a player at the table. It's call them out. We're going to call them out into public. Whoever had their name called the most is the threat. Creatures attacking the threat cannot be blocked. If the threat is dealt more than 13 damage in one turn, players vote for a new threat. That's pretty cool. I like that. I think that's very, very, very cutesy. And it sounds fun. Very politically type of card, in my opinion. But nice, we submit cards via Discord. I don't... What do I got this thing here for? It's not here for decoration. Just because Reddit sucks. Reddit just absolutely... sucks for looking up cards. It's terrible. Okay, we got Cleanse. That, I believe, is an actual card name. So you're already disqualified by... I think there's a card called Cleanse. So you're already choosing a name of a card that already exists. Warzov, 3 generic for a legendary instant. When you cast this, remove all poison counters from all players. All your opponents take that much, and you gain life equal to the amount dealt. What the hell does this mean? So when you cast this, remove all poison counters from all players. So that's a cast ability? Like, what's the point of it even being an instant? All your opponents take that much poison? Remove all poison counters. All your opponents take that much, and you gain life. This card doesn't make enough sense. First off, I don't think it's fair that the card just automatically resolves because it was a cast trigger. I also just don't even like... I don't even know what this means. So it's like, if there are 10 poison counters, you take them all off and then give all the opponents the poison counters at the same time. Makes really no sense. Gain health equal to the amount of poison counters and drain your opponents for the same amount. All your opponents take that much. What does that mean, take that much, though? Not clear. Instructions, very unclear. Do not like it. Get it out of here. I will purge this world of the plague that has infiltrated it. Not a fan. Okay, let's do one of Bacon Catbug's Phantasmal Flickering. It's probably going to be half a year before everyone uses the Discord. But we'll get there. We'll get there, people. We'll hold our hands together. Okay, we got a blue-white 2 generic instant. Exile target non-creature... Exile target non-token creature you control with 3x counters on it. Oh, sorry. 3x counters on it. If it doesn't have suspend, it gains suspend. Create a token copy of it. What? So we exile a non-token creature... With three time counters on it? How do you even do that? What are you talking about? Are you trying to blink something that has suspend? It's not even in play. You can't exile. Like, it's already suspended. Why would... I don't think this card can exist. Can someone help me? Like, is this possible? Are there any cards with time counters in play? Because that's the only thing that you can exile. Like you, or blink, or whatever you want to do. It actually looks like you're trying to blink a card that's already suspended and make another copy of it, which doesn't exist. It's not possible. It exiles it, then places 3 time counters on it and suspends it. You control... Oh! I see. You exile it and you give it 3 counters. So it began, and then it gets suspend, and you get a copy of it. That sounds fine with me. It's also very expensive, so be very, very fair. I'm not really familiar with the cards that give a card suspend all of a sudden. It exiles it, places 3 time counters on it, and suspends it at the same time. Yeah, you exile it, then put the time counters on it. I'm assuming this is templated properly, and I'm just an idiot. That's how I'm going to interpret it. Okay. Freebie section. Wither Away! The black one generic instant. Target creature has base toughness 0 until end of turn. So it's like... That's actually sort of cool! So it's like removal? Unless the opponent has counters on it. Because if it has counters, like a +1/+1 counter on it, then it won't die. Then it'll have a base power, and it'll have base toughness of like 0. It also doesn't remove the power, so it's not very good. It could be good in blocking. I guess you can attack with a 1/1. They block, you give it Wither Away if it had 1/+1/+1 counter on it. I like it. It's a very unique removal spell. We don't have anything like this. You think this dangerous? It's a 2-mana! Kill many things, but not even kill everything. Oh, gets around indestructible. You have indestructible? Useless. Completely useless. Finally, you wither away. Of any kind of buff? Yeah, you can buff a creature all you want. It'll just wither away to 0. That's just Heartless Act. Maybe it is. Yeah, kills the indestructibles. I think that's a pretty I think it's a clever card design. I'm a huge fan of this thing. Yeah, goodbye, Toski. Toski, you thought you're indestructible. Well, not today. Not anymore at all. That, for that matter. Okay, next up, let's look at Stanel, Inevitable End. Yeah, thank you. And also, thank you very much telling me where it is. I am, by default, going to assume, is on my Discord. Inevitable End. It is a... Okay, we got for a red instant. Target player loses the game. What are you... What's this? No! Is that... This is the most broken card of all time. Are they still buying it? Chris Cox to Cynthia Williams. It's more of a Wizards of the Coast joke than anything else. Yeah, it's a little strong. Just a little too strong. Maybe we've got to add one colorless to it to balance it out. Yeah, next up, let's look at Disseminating Ooze. It is a Golgari, 2 generic, 2/2 ooze. Mutated creatures remain on Disseminating Ooze as it moves to any zone other than a player's hand or library. Mutated creatures remain on this thing as it moves to any zone other than, so like if it were to die, it goes to Disseminating Ooze? Then Golgari, 1 generic, choose target creature card in your graveyard, put that card underneath Disseminating Ooze, then whenever a creature you control mutates, you may pay another 4 mana, and return Disseminating Ooze from your graveyard to the battlefield. I think this is fine. I think it's clunky as hell. I think it's super clunky. What does he even do? This causes it to mutate. Oh, so the idea is anytime this creature becomes part of the Disseminating Ooze, it just mutates onto it. Finally, making Mutate even remotely playable. Because otherwise, Mutate sort of sucks. Mutate is a counterintuitive mechanic. Correction! Mutate just isn't a clear mechanic at all, and doesn't even make any sense. Too complicated, plus feels dumb and useless. Shred. Well, that is just the Mutate mechanic, period. This person's trying to make Mutate, like, reasonably playable. Except it's not. We're sorry, like, except Mutate is not. Hopefully it gives it some chance. Some breath of life. Okay, next up, let's look at, Toads has a card, apparently. Hey, Nikachu, the old man figured it out. Please do the bringer cards for Blatonic. Thanks. Happy Valentine's Day. Oh, happy Valentine's Day to everybody. Thank you very much. What is the name of your post? Oh, you put something over here. We have Indiana. Is this it? People are posting a lot of stuff. Okay, I'm assuming this is your series. Can't even see this series very well. Can we? Well, everyone's gonna make do with what they can see around here. That's all I'm gonna say. You gotta make do with what you can see. We got Indiana Jones, a white 2 generic 3/4 human with Whiplash. When Indiana Jones attacks, he gets +2/+0 protection from snakes and artifacts. That is very, very fair. Next, we got Bringer of Pain. It's a 9-mana 5/5 bringer. And it's also got a Picasso art. You may spend Wooburg rather than pay the spell's mana cost. It has haste, and whenever it enters the battlefield, it deals damage to target creature equal to the converted mana cost used to cast it. What? So hold on. When it enters the battlefield, it deals to target creature equal to the converted mana cost used. So basically, it's like Flame Tongue Cavu for like one more mana. We've got Bring Out the Bringer. Frexian 5 mana. Or you can pay Wooburg to play it. Search your library for a bringer card. Shuffle your library and put that card third from the top. You have one simple one. Diminishing Portal, 6 mana. Each player sacrifices all Eldrazi they control. Alright, thank you very much for your the super chats and the cards. I think they're all actually quite fine. Especially the 6 mana sorcery, sack all them Eldrazis. Get them out of here! Here we got bringers. A new legion of bringers. A new wave of bringers are on their way. Now next up, hope everyone's catching this one. It's your mom! It is a green, black, 2 generic, 0/4 human horror. Tap another human. Create a 1/1 black horror creature token. Pay 2, sack of food. Put a +0/+1 counter on your mom. Poor templating over here. Very, very poor templating. You can press enter and let the whole your mom thing hit the second sentence. When your mom leaves the battlefield, put a number of +1/+1 counters on each horror equal to the number of counters on your mom. Now, that being said, this is very, very fair. Nothing wrong here. Yeah, hi, mom. Hello there. Everyone should feel offended. Everyone should feel offended by your mom. Okay, next up, we've got from Alex. Thank you so much, Alex, for supporting the channel. Here's one from my sister who plays Rakdos. Aurora, the Blood Queen. Okay, let's look up Aurora. Nice! It is a red, black, 2 generic, 4/2 human warlock. First strike, protection from blue and green. That's a lot of protection. What about white? Tap, destroy target legendary permanent. Oh my god! That sounds terrible. This would just break. I have a feeling this is the type of card that would get banned in Commander. It's like Caracas the creature. Is there not a Caracas creature? It's like something. I'm pretty sure there is a Caracas keep creature. I'm gonna get to every. I'm doing all the series cards on the second half. Brawly Shadow. All the series cards, second half. trying to get through enough freebie cards at the beginning of the show that the freebie players can feel like they were on a show, on a Nikachu MTG show. It does say non-land. Well, that's great. Destroy target. Oh, it doesn't even say non-land. Just destroy target legendary permanent. Get him out of here. This actually seems broken. Well, okay, it's not broken, but it's like a super unfun card. Like, if this thing is active, you just keep blowing up someone's commander every single time that enters the battlefield. If you keep untapping this thing, you have a means of, like, tapping, blow something up, untap, blow someone else's commander up. It's not going to be a good time for those people. Not going to be a good time at all. And all the opponents and commander will target you. That they will. That they would. Now, is it a good card? Absolutely, it's a good card. Is it overpowered? Probably not. Would it get banned in commander? I don't know. It looks like the type of card that would. It's like, this is the anti-fun card. It's like for the same reasons that they banned, same reason that they banned Caracas. Anyway, cool card. Okay, we got Prophetic Parotes. Parotes. Parutes. I don't know how to pronounce this. Blue instant, draw a card. Put Prophetic Parotes on top of its owner's library. Then you may look at the top three cards of your library and put them back in any order. Ooh. So we draw the card first. So we draw a random card. Then you could put the top cards back in any order. You could put this thing on top so you can draw it next turn. Does that even matter? You keep casting something like this? I guess this is okay? It's like the reverse ponder. Because that's what it is. It's just reverse ponder. You draw a random card. Although the next card after this is not going to be very random. Not very random at all. Actually, maybe is it more broken? Yeah, maybe this is more broken than ponder. This is probably way worse than ponder. Or is it just Sensei's Divining Top? Sensei's Divining Top is pay 3 mana. You pay 1 to look at the top 3 cards. You pay nothing to put it back on top. I guess it's the same thing. Maybe it's not so bad after all. Although Sensei's Divining Top may be very fair in Commander. Super banned in one-on-one magic. Alright. It's like a top. It's not a Sensei Divining Top. It's a Prophetic Perutz Top. Whatever the hell that means. Next up, oh my god, Bacon Cat Bug, you have so many here. Next up we'll go, okay, we'll do another Bacon Cat Bug one. Joe Chill. I am not familiar with the lore. It's a black, white, 1/1 human rogue. When Joe Chill enters the battlefield, sacrifice 2 other humans. If you do, put 2 +1/+1 counters, a menace counter, a death touch counter on target human you control. Maybe it's going to be Joe Chill. It's a bat in addition to its other types. A bat? Nothing personal, kid. Okay, sure, that's fine. I don't know where this is from, though. It's like some sort of comic or movie or cartoon show that I am just not familiar. Is it Batman? Joe Chill enters the battlefield, sacrifice 2 other humans. Oh, Batman's parents? If you do, put 2 +1/+1 counters, a menace counter, a death touch counter on target human. But Batman, it can't be Batman. It's gotta be on, what was the Joe Chill the Joker? It's a bat and no. You're talking about Batman is the death touch? Batman is harmless. He's more of a detective than a police officer, if you know what I mean. Joe Chill killed his parents. Joe is actually chill, but kind of weak. Ship for flavor. Oh my goodness. All right. Cool card. Populism. White enchantment. As long as an opponent controls more lands than you, spells you cast have convoke. As long as an opponent controls more lands. Oh, that's cool. As long as... Oh, but you'd be cool if this applied to everybody. So as long as... Yeah, so long as an opponent has more lands than you, then your stuff has Convoke. Or maybe does it, would it do that? Do you hear the music? Or are you just saying, oh, it's music time? It is music time. Love the card! Cool, janky stuff. We all love that stuff. You know what we also love? We also love our sponsors. FusionGamingOnline.com, the place I go get all my Magic the Gathering cards, whether it be from Murders at Karlov Manor, whether it be from the Lost Caverns of Ixalan. I'm actually trying to find some damn stern scoldings, and you know, I'm gonna get them at fusiongamingonline.com. Also, remember, there's a deal of the week every single week. This week, it is save 15% off all Mirrodin block singles. But even if you're too late for that deal of the week, they'll have another deal every single week for different sets, cards, sleeves, accessories, and more. And don't forget, you can use coupon code Nikachu at checkout to get an additional 5% off all your purchases. We're also going to thank Mana Traders, the premier place for renting Magic cards online. Play Commander for the first time digitally, because you can't do that on Arena, but on Magic Online, you can play Competitive Commander, you can play Casual Commander, you can play Power 1 Commander. I can't remember. You can give, like, a notification to the community, Power 3, but we're playing seriously, or something to that effect, or Power 5, Power 6, but only good vibes. I've seen those messages before. You can do that when you're renting cards online. On Magic Online, through Mana Traders, you can support the channel using my Mana Traders link in the description below or save 10% off your first 2 months using coupon code Nikachu underscore ZWX. ZWX, for those Americans out there. There will be like, Nikachu, we don't know what you're talking about. Zed? What is that? Oh, and give me a second. I don't have my drink with me. What's a coffee crew without my coffee? I was drinking it for drinking it for breakfast. Kaiser Emotion, hey, I watch almost all your videos. First time managing to catch a stream live. Welcome, Kaiser. Okay, time for the big series. All right, it's the Bacon Cat Bug Show. It is now. Dryad Arbor's friends. All right, Dryad Arbor's friends, plus a random instant, you say? Hold on, what do you have, anything? Love the show. Also forget the which ones I already did, so sorry for any repeats. Yeah, I think we might have seen one of these. Okay, so we got the Prairie Nomad. It's a 0/2 defender, but it's a plains human, so you can fetch it out with something like Flooded Strand and his defender. I actually think this is probably annoying, but fine. I hate control decks having access to a random blocker at the last second. I would just hate it. The Shoal Peacock, 0/1 island bird with flying. Also very fair. Also another annoying thing to block out of nowhere. The Mire Ooze, 2/1 land. What are you, nuts? It's got decayed. A creature with decayed can't block. Okay, and when it attacks, you have to sacrifice it. Okay, actually, you balanced that one out quite well. I got a little too excited. Got excited by accident around there. 2/1 creature, you just flash into play through fetch lands. That would have been broken. Okay, we got the Crag Lion. It's a 2/1 mountain lion. It can't attack or block alone. Stronger numbers. That one might be broken. Now, red players, they got tons of creatures. They got the humans. Sometimes they have humans. They got the goblins. They've got the elementals. They got like a lot. They love the swarm strategies. Low the ground, get you dead really quickly. The Crag Lion actually, that one might be a problem. A 2/1 that has to attack with other creatures, that's like not a big deal for the red decks. Hey Terry, just letting you know, given the fact that I get so many super chats for cards that I can only look up the cards that are super chatted, which you can submit in my Discord. Vengeful, you also can submit cards just for the hell of it in the Discord as well, and just show it off to the community. Vengeful Repost. It is a red instant. Until end of turn, target creature gains. When this creature dies, if it wasn't sacrificed, it deals damage equal to its power to target player or planeswalker it's attacking. This is a rereader. Target creature gains. Until end of turn, target creature gains. When this creature dies. Okay, so if it hit the bin. It deals damage equal to its power to target player or planeswalker it's attacking. So it needs to be attacking if it's an attacking creature. Okay, cool. Totally fair. I think it's fair. Think AI has anything to do with Wizards laying off so many people in the last little while? Nope! I think the economy going down, and I think Hasbro's sinking operations that are not Wizards of the Coast are the reason they're laying off people like crazy. Brawly Shadow, the Phantom Thieves of Heart. Holy moly. Okay, hold on. There's like a, I think there's like a rule, five at a time. You're breaking that rule. I'm gonna go, I'm gonna look at one half of this. I'm gonna look at the other half somewhere else in the show. Okay, we have a red, black, blue, 2/2, human rogue, first strike reach. Whenever a non-token creature you don't own dies, you can pay two. When you do, create a token that is a copy of that creature, except it's a spirit in addition to its other types. Actually, really fair, interesting card. The idea is to swipe your opponent's stuff and then make copies of it. Next up, I like the old, I love your full art cards. We got Mona the Magician, a white one generic 1/2 cat rogue with ward 3. Whenever you gain life, investigate. This ability triggers only once each turn. Pay a white, tap, sacrifice X clues to discover X. X can't be zero. Very, another nicely balanced card. We got Skull the Chariot, a white, red, 2 generic 4/3 human rebel with haste. Whenever Skull the Chariot attacks, you may discard a card. If you do, draw a card and put a +1/+1 counter on Skull. Whenever you discard a card, Skull deals 2 damage to each opponent. That card is insane. I would not be happy about playing against this thing. So it's like a discard outlet, which triggers a lot of cards, by the way. Things like, what's it called? Madness. And also it has immediate haste. And when you just, so it's effectively dealing maybe 7 damage for 4 mana. I don't think this is fair at all. F that. If you do, you draw a card too, so you just keep them away. I think this is a little pushed. I can't even block this 2 damage, and it deals it to with damage effect. It's a 5/4 haste. That cycles through your cards. It's not like you're even paying anything. That plus madness, I think that's insane. Okay, we got Panther the Lovers, red 2 generic 1/3 human. Whenever you cast a spell, you may put a concentrate counter on Panther the Lovers. Whenever Panther attacks, remove any number of counters from it. Panther deals that much damage, divided as you choose among any number of targets. Cast a spell, put a concentration counter. Attacks, remove any number of counters. That's fair. That's a lot of work to deal just a little bit of damage. That's a lot of work. Okay, we'll look at more of them on later. We'll look at it later. Okay, next up we got Gabrielle. Just to make it more visible, I would advise you to put a price on set review, 5 or more cards. Probably. I'm probably going to jack it. This is going to be the last time you're going to get for $2, people. But the problem is, if someone pays for $2, I don't know what I'm going to do. What, like, ignore the super chat? Because in exchange, I'll flash the super chat. 5 or more cards to avoid having too many of them take all the time. That's why I'm trying to spread them out on the second half of the show. On the second half of the show, if you're a die-hard core fan of the custom card shows, well, it goes on forever. Otherwise, I'm trying to sort of manage it out on the first 30 minutes. And thank you very much for that super chat, Gabrielle. Because you didn't suggest anything. You didn't give it to the freebie section. We did assess the threat. We're also gonna have decisive evidence. It's a 3-man. Hold on, was this a super chat? I think that was a super chat. Okay, whatever. Decisive evidence. 3-mana clue. Tap, add 1 mana of any color. Pay 2, sacrifice decisive evidence. Draw a card. When you do, solve up to 1 target case. I don't know exactly what that means, but this seems very, very crappy. 3 mana to add one mana, sack it, solve up to 1 target case. I think that sounds very, very underwhelming. Am I wrong here? I think that's a very, very, very underwhelming card. Is it broken? Are you kidding me? $3 a card? Oh, thank you so much, Bali Shadow. Well, the biggest concern I have with the show is going over 2 hours. Even over an hour and a half is a lot. The best shows are short and sweet. Okay, next up we go with Bryce. Thank you very much. The Creature of Many Colors by Bebro. Is the Creature of many colors. Is this someone else's card? Hold on, did you post it on Reddit? How dare you. The Creature of Many Colors, posted by Bebro. I can't find this. The creature of many colors. The creature of many colors. This is why I use my Discord. This is exactly why I use my Discord. Because Reddit sucks. It's not good for looking up any. It is not Google. It is not Google at all. And I don't want to spend so much time digging for these cards, right? Creature of many colors by Bebro. Is that, can I find that here? Bebro. No, no search results on my Discord. Yeah, Reddit is bad for anything. Okay, I'm sorry. I am eating the super chat. I can't find it easily. So I'm going to donate it to the freebie section. Donating to the freebie section. We got the Detoxifier. The Orzhov, Orzhov 2 generic 1-4 human cleric. When Detoxifier enters the battlefield, remove all poison counters from target player and deal that much damage to that player. What? Target player. Didn't we just have a card like this? So it was like so similar. It's like remove all the poison counters. Well, at least this was clear. It deals damage to that player. We also Orzhov, Orzhov tap, remove 2 poison counters from target player and deal that much damage to that. Why are we, so like we're detoxification, so we're removing the poison, but we're still like smacking them in the face. That seems a bit rude, in my opinion. It's totally fine though. I guess in some ways it's good. It's on discard now? Okay, hold on. Yeah, Reddit's banned now. I can't find it still. It's gotta be in the custom MTG card section. It's not in the coffee crew section, right? Oh, the creature of many color. Oh, why can't I find it? The creature of many. For some reason, it wasn't going through. Anyway, thank you very much. Okay, we got a 4-mana Snick. It's a 3/4. If the creature of many colors is your commander, choose a color before the game begins. The creature of many colors is the chosen color. Partner with any legendary creature. You can have 2 commanders if this creature is one of them. 100% fine. Is there, what's the, so I don't get it. What's the benefit of this card? Just to have a random extra commander to be paired up with your commander? It's a generic commander. It can be any color you want. It's a 3/4 creature. Can deal a little bit more commander damage, I guess, somewhere deep in the game. Plus 1 color to a commander deck. Oh, so if you like, if you want to be Jeskai, but you have one commander that's Azorius, this one could be red, and then you could pair them up. Oh, that's cool. Is that broken? Probably not. I think that's a banger idea. That's actually a really neat idea. Has this been done before, or is this like a unique idea? Doesn't need to be legendary to be a partner. Probably you're right. There is probably a slight problem with this card. Oops. Isn't there something similar with partner already? Maybe. I think the card needs to say this creature can be your commander. Probably that too. It's the Prismatic Piper ripoff. That's fine. It's a snick. There's all sorts of... don't you want a snick? You want, everyone wants a little bit of a snick. Okay, next up let's look at... Okay, let's take up a Majra special. All right, let's read. Let's attempt to read these. Hello, everyone. Here's the actual last deck of the 5 first deck I made a long time ago. The 5 first cards from part 1 of Eternity. Oh, God. Why do you use these, like, words that I can't look up very well? Part 1 of the... I don't know if it's going to look it up. Thank God I was able to find it. It's very that's complicated. That's very complicated. Okay, we got... Start off with Nora, the Etherwise. Red, black, blue, 1 generic, 3/4 human spirit wizard. Flying. For Arachdos, target spirit you control has persist until end of turn. Blue. Remove 3 -1/-1 counters among creatures you control. Counter target's ability or non-creature spell. Exile an arcane... An arcane from your graveyard? Oh, we're bringing arcane back, are we? That's a, as far as I'm concerned, a pretty useless card type. And you can add any of the Wooburg. I think this is all fair. Nothing, this does a lot of stuff, and at the same time, it does nothing super broken. Livia is a red, black, blue, 2 generic, 3/3 spirit human wizard with persist and a lifelink. It is also enters the battlefield, choose one or both. Put target spirit creature card creature from your graveyard on the battlefield. That's really strong. Put target arcane card from your graveyard to your hand. That is completely useless as far as I'm concerned. Whenever you cast your first arcane spell from your hand each turn, if the spell didn't have rebound, it gains rebound. You might actually be trying to make arcane good. Because back then, well, I mean, most of the arcane spells are pretty underwhelming. Don't quote me on that, Storm players. I know there's some arcane spells that are rituals. You'd love to have double ritual. Lewillin, the Ethernal Geist. For 3 mana, we have a 2/3 human spirit wizard, flying wither persist. Enter the battlefield, distribute X -1 counters among any number of creatures your opponents control, where X is the number of spirits you control and the number of spirit and arcane cards in your graveyard. Just trying to make bad cards good. There's nothing wrong with that. We have the Aether Mansion. Hope I pronounced that right. For Rakdos. It's a 2/2 human wizard. Again with wither. Why do they all have wither? Okay, when it dies, choose one or both. Target arcane in your graveyard gains flashback until end of turn, or return target spirit card in your graveyard to your hand. Got a little bit of spirits and arcane synergy there. And the Aether Magician's Fury, a red X. It's also an arcane spell. Deals X damage to any target. In combination with the rest of these cards, it's probably incredibly fair. Stupid train internet. I'm 10 minutes behind on buffering now. Yeah, I feel the same way when I'm in an airplane. I just started paying for the internet on the airplane. You know, I'm like, I'm spending like $1,500 on this trip. What's another $30 to use the internet while I'm on the airplane? Okay, next up. Who's next up? Okay, let's look at... Who hasn't got any card yet? Stanel! Fixed it. Inevitable End 2. Thank you very much for your super chat and your cards. Inevitable... End. There we go. We found it. You fixed it? Okay, this is the sequel. So they banned the first... They had to... Let's just assume this was an arena special. It was like... it was an alchemy card. For one red, everyone loses. So for an it's now an instant. Target player loses the game. If this spell is countered, the caster of this spell loses the game instead. Any player may pay 19 life to redirect this spell. Oh my god. But hold on, like... It just won't do anything. So I target player 1. Player 1 pays 19 life to send it at player 2. Oh no, it won't work like that. Okay, I target player 1. Player 1 spends 19 life to redirect it to me, the original caster. I pay 19 life to redirect it to player 2. Player 2 redirects it back at me, and I lose. Because I can't redirect it any more times. So basically, it's a death sentence, and it just turns the game into garbage. One person will live with, like... Oh, no, it's 19 life. Sorry, in command, you have 40 life. So everyone redirects it. If in the end, someone's going to end up with, like, 20th-something life. Everyone can... And the original player can only... The original caster can only redirect it twice. It is more fair than the last one. Feels like an AI-generated card. I think someone put some thought into this card. They put some truly some thought into this. I try to kill you. 19 life, go back at you. 19 life, go back at you. 19 life, go back at you. 19 life, go back at... How does that work? 19, 19, 19, 19. They lose. So I still can kill somebody if I keep going after one person. But then any random person can pay 19 life to make it go back at me, and then I'm dead. It might make some sense, but I'm terrible at art. Anyway, I think it's too broken. Still too broken. We broke the game too easily. Okay, next up, let's go with Oscar. Henry Beer Artist. Thank you very much for your super chat. Ooh, I like it. I like the picture. Okay, so we've got a white, 2 generic, 1/6 human crafter. Crafting some beer over there. pay one tap, create two beer tokens. A beer token is a colorless artifact with tap, sack a beer, draw one card, and add one mana of any color. Beer deals 3 damage to you! Oh my god. Why would beer deal damage? Sure, it kills some brain cells, but not that many. I don't think it's worth a shot in the face. It should be called Tavern Brawl. Create 2 beer tokens and also get punched in the face for like 3 damage or something. Okay, next up. Anyway, I think it's fun. It's fine. I understand why it has Defender. It's a good old Swords to Plowshares, and then from Plowshares to Beer Vendor. It's still only 1 mana, though. It is 1 mana. That's correct. The ability is only 1 mana. Nikachu, all those poison equal damage cards are like that because the OG card that removed poison leeches did that. Ah, so paying homage to the leeches. Bacon Cat Bug. Cycle of 1 blue counter spells with a 1 million kicker. Sounds crazy. A cycle of 1 blue. 1 million kicker? 1 million kicker, you say. Blue, 1 generic, instant. Kicker of 2 and white and 1 generic. Okay, counter up to 1 target spell that targets a permanent you control. If a spell was countered this way, draw a card. Okay, that targets a permanent. Okay, that's fine. And if a spell was kicked, exile up to 1 target permanent you control, then return it to the battlefield under its owner's control. It's actually a really well-designed card. You build a little bit of counter spell. And it's a narrow counter spell. It's not like anything. It's like it's only for protection. And you get a little bit of a blink action going on with it. And then we got Umiya's Ultimatum. It's a blue 1 generic with a kicker of blue 1 generic. Counter target spell. If that spell is countered this way, put it on top of its owner's library instead of into its player's graveyard. If the spell was kicked, exile target spell or ability instead. This is Memory Lapse. The spell is countered this way. It's super Memory Lapse. It's probably honestly a little bit fine anyway. So it's 4 mana, just exile the damn thing. Beer could also loot instead of draw, since you'd be unsteady from the alcohol. That's right. Platonic liquid nose. Beer damages you because of alcohol poisoning? Well, over many years. You know, not immediately. It's not like you drink a beer and all of a sudden, ugh, that hurt. Doesn't work like that. Okay, I think this card is cool. I think it's a fresh design. Although it might be strong. Memory Lapse isn't in Modern, but it's not in Legacy, that's for sure. Or it's not played in Legacy, even though it's legal. Brexana's Bumbling, a blue 1 generic instant. Kicker of black 1 generic. Counter target spell unless its controller pays 2. If the spell is kicked, search its owner's graveyard, hand, and library for all the cards with the same name as that card and exile them. Love that card, that is cool. That might be a little too strong for the black decks. The Dimir decks, but I don't care. Rakaya's Ruse, blue 1 generic with a kicker of red 1 generic. Counter target artifact or creature spell unless its controller pays 4. 4 mana! Who has that much mana these days? We're on a budget in 2024. If this spell was kicked, Rakaya's Ruse deals damage equal to the target spell's mana value to target player that player controls. And Gaia's Grace. Very graceful guy is. Blue 1 generic with a kicker of green 1 generic. If it was kicked, create 2 1-1 green sapling creature tokens, then populate. That actually, this might be the strongest card. 4 mana for 4 creatures and you counter a spell. Counter target spell unless its controller pays 1 for each creature you control. That's busted. I think that actually is a little bit strong. The front end actually sucks. The back end is insane. And you populate. I think this is very, very, very strong. I'd be a little fearful of this one. I don't want to give this to like banned control decks. If it was not Simic, I would say print it. Yeah, it'd be harder in a non-Simic deck. But it's Simic, so it is very easy. Okay, let's go to the second half of Brawly Shadow's gigantic super chat. The Phantom Thieves of Heart. The Phantom Thieves! Alright, so we did the first 5. Go to the next 5. Oh, we got a white, blue, one generic 3/2 human advisor with vigilance. Whenever a creature you control deals combat damage to a player, you investigate. And then tap, sack a clue, target creature gains first strike until end of turn. Brawly knows how to make balanced cards. That's all I'm going to say. And pick nice art for them cards. Next up, we've got Oracle the Hermit. It is a red, blue, 0/3. Whenever Oracle the Hermit becomes the target of a spell or ability you don't control, you scry 3. You also can pay a red, blue, tap, scry 1. And as you scry, you may reveal and exile any number of the scryed cards. You may cast cards exiled this way until the end of the turn. Now, is that fine? As you scry, you can reveal and exile any number of the scryed cards. And you can, so basically it's all card draw. This card might be very dangerous. Does it danger? So it gets hard, you can scry for one. You can scry a million different ways. So scrying is just card draw. You can reveal and exile and just play the cards. Yeah, that's broken. I think that's broken. No way. I think with this, plus, like, you know, pawn, like, stuff like Preordain and a bunch of other scrying machines, it would just be unbelievably broken. This just turns into the most insane card draw possible. The stream could be called the Persona and Eternity stream at this point. That's possible. Did I only do the first four? 1, 2, 3, 4. I didn't do this one? Oh, I didn't do the Fox Emperor. Okay, I'll get through the second half. We'll do all of them. We have a blue 2 generic 3/3 human artificer with Ward X, where X is the number of tokens you control. And then pay X, tap, discard a card, create a token. That's a copy of target non-token creature with mana value X, except it's blue and red. Except it's blue and has. You may spend blue mana as though it were mana of any color to activate this and creature's abilities. I think that's okay. I think it's okay. This is like, make a non-token target of non-token creature with mana value X. So it's like you're cheating creatures onto the battlefield. Create a token. But you still have to pay the same mana value. I think it's okay. Next up. Noir the Empress. We have a white, green, 2 generic, 4/3 human noble with reach, landfall. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, create a food token. Food you control, have tap, sacrifice this artifact, prevent the next 2 damage that would be dealt to you or a permanent you control. Very fair. What is this? Oh, it's a double-sided card. Akichi, Prodigal Detective, black, blue, white, 2/2, human detective, ward 2, whenever a non-token creature dies, investigate, sacrifice 5 clues, transform Akichi, Prodigal Detective, and it's a 3/3 human assassin with hexproof, whenever a non-token creature dies, investigate, whenever you sacrifice a clue, go target creature and put a counter on it. It says ward 2 off the get-go. Yeah, that's okay. I think it's okay. We have another double-sided card. We have Yoshizawa, Echo of Denial. White, blue, 1/2 human. First strike training. Whenever Yoshizawa, Echo of Denial attacks, transform it. So all you have to do is attack. Your training is done. One attack, and that's all you need. And it transforms. Transform it if it has 4 or more counters on it. And it turns into Violet the Faith. It is a 2/3 human rogue, can't be blocked, and whenever Violet the Faith deals combat damage to a player, you may untap up to X permanents where X is the damage dealt. This card seems insane. It's got training, so it gets bigger when something other bigger than it attacks. Something to that effect. I don't remember what the training thing does. It needs to train 4 times. Transform it as 4. Oh, I see. If it has 4 more counters on it. Okay, that actually is very, very fair. Very, very fair. Okay, cool. Because if it flipped immediately, well, that would just be stupid. Stupid insane. We got Nick. Nick here with Treasure. Just submitted to the Discord. Should be a little bit more defining. Okay, we got Treasure the Token. Token artifact treasure. Tap, flip a coin. If you win the flip, add three mana of any one color, then sacrifice this artifact. If you lose the flip, treasure loses all abilities and becomes a 3/3 artifact creature under target opponent's control. So you're basically taking a chance here. You're rolling the dice. Maybe we're gonna get three mana. Maybe you give somebody a beast token. To some extent. Platonic Liquid, thank you very much for your super chat. For never was a story of more woe. All right, we got it. It is a red 2 generic saga. Chapter 1, gain control of target creature you control. Is it like gain back control of the creature? Okay, so gain control of target creature you control and target creature you don't control. They become a lover in addition to their other creature types. And gain, this creature can't attack or block. Sounds like a very Romeo and Juliet tale. Chapter 2, tap target lover you control and put 2 stun counters on it. What? Chapter 3, if you control a tapped lover, sacrifice another lover. If you do, sacrifice a lover. If you control a tapped lover, sacrifice another lover. If you do, sacrifice a lover. So basically, you're sacrificing both of them. A story of woe. One died, so the other one went with it. Yeah, I think it's just very Romeo and Juliet-like, if I understand correctly. They got out of the fight. They're not fighting. They can let the two families duke it out themselves. I think Romeo and Juliet is the point. Aha, I know my Shakespeare. Or at least I know that one story. Can't say I know a lot of stories out there. Okay, let's get some... a lot of people are buried under the Bacon Catbug Majra train here. So let's look at Spartan Speedruns. You've got Still Sick Super Mario Sunshine. I made an entire deck around this using SMS theme cards. And this card is the commander in Discord. It's a... Super Mario Sunshine. Huh? Made entire deck using SMS theme cards. Still... Well, what's the title of the card? You have to give me the title of your card, you know. I made an entire deck around this using SMS... And this is the card. And this card is the commander. Super Mario... Is the card called... Oh, it is. Okay. When you post cards to the Discord, you gotta also use the text. So you gotta give it a title, Super Mario Sunshine, so that when I look it up, like, I can search it up. Because if you don't, Discord can't read your card. That's the problem. Okay, I'm lucky it wasn't too difficult to find. We got White Simic and Arachdos for a 3/3 video game creature. I like that. We got video game creatures around here. Whenever Super Mario Sunshine deals combat damage to a player, create a 1/1 shine sprite creature token with flying. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you control 5 or more shine sprite creatures, you win the game. Is it really that hard to get that many shrine sprite? So, deals combat damage to a player, create a 1/1. If you create, what if you populate? Can't you cheat by populating? And since when was Mario Rakdos in any degree? I mean, maybe when he, gets a fire flower, he's red. But outside of that, I think he's just, I think he's just, a white creature. A beacon of light and courage. Mario harnesses the power of the shine sprites to restore harmony to the Isle of Delfino. I think I've played every single Mario game except Mario Sunshine. Was that for the GameCube? I skipped that one. I'm sorry, Nintendo. I did not pledge my allegiance by getting that one. But I didn't get any other game console. He's Wooburg since Sunshine and Rainbows. Oh! I think I can buy that. Okay, let's look at... Bacon Catbug. Powder that makes you say yes. What the hell is this? Okay, pay 1 artifact. If a spell or ability states a player may perform an action, they must choose to perform that action if able. I have no idea if this breaks the game or not, but I like it. Do you pay the 1? You have to pay the 1. If you can, you must. Okay, next we'll take a one from Majra, Utana Tenjo. Also, thank you very much for your super chat. Utana. At least your cards have super unique names. Okay, we have a white, red, 3 generic, 3/3 human citizen. Partner with Himemia Anthe. Also has haste. Whenever you cast a spell by its miracle, draw a card, and target creature gets +X/+0. First strike in lifelink until end of turn, where X is that spell's mana value. Untap it. So whenever you cast a spell by its miracle... Okay, this is another miracle card. We're still adding on to all the miracle mechanic. Sure, fine. And you have a partner card here. Majra has... The other one. Anthe. I'm just going to call it... I'm just going to call her Anthe. Okay, we got Anthe over here. Black, blue, 2 generic, 2/4 human, warlock, noble. So it's like a... This person is like a witch of some sort. Because they're a warlock. Can partner with Utuna. Wizards and warlocks you control have whenever this creature deals combat damage to a player, exile the top card of their library face down. You may look at and play those cards for as long as they remain exiled. If you cast a spell this way, you may spend mana as though it were mana of any type to cast it. Good enough for me. Good enough for me. Ben is like, I want this card. Incredibly ancient memes. Very, 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 very ancient. Let's take something from Palette Jam. Thank you very much for your super chat. Olympic Caltrop Thrower. What the hell is this? Oops, he threw too far. Could be true. I've seen videos of, like, javelin throwing, and, like, the officials get their foot stubbed with the javelin. Like, they just didn't expect the person to throw the javelin that far. I don't even know why they're on the damn field. It seems insane to me. Okay. Olympic Caltrop Thrower. We got a red 6/1 demon athlete with haste. As Olympic Caltrop Thrower enters the battlefield, each opponent creates an artifact token with whenever this creature attacks you and is unblocked, this artifact deals 1 damage to it. So, enters the battlefield, each opponent creates an artifact token whenever a creature attacks you and is unblocked. So they all get, like, this permanent, you get damaged. Sorry, when you get attacked. I understand what you're trying to do. The flavor is just weird. So it's like, it should just be something like, whenever a creature attacks and is not blocked, it deals 1 damage to somebody. That would just, like, feel, make a little bit more sense to me. Other than that, this card is fine. It's pretty... Oh, hold on, wait a minute. It's a 6/1 with haste? What am I talking about? This is insane. I forgot, like, ability is fine. Oh, 3 mana, 6/1, haste, does not sacrifice at end of turn, like ball lightning? Oh, no, get it out of here. Those far believed in always putting 110% effort into his throws. 100, you gotta put 110% around here. So you give them Caltrops instead of the middle of the field. Uh-huh. Or an emblem? Yeah, emblem would make some sense, too. That actually makes some sense. Yeah, it's ball lightning. Except we're throwing the balls now. Hit a ref, get a point. Yes, you get extra points for the refs. Okay, next up. Let's look at... Vitron Espada has one. Name is Walkin' on Discord. Thank you very much for the name, but I need just the name of the card. And it's your burgeoning painter. Burgeoning. Okay, hold on. Painter. Let's look up. Paintor. Damn it! You want to look up Walkin'? It's not showing what I want to see. You gotta give me the name. Okay, hold on. Where did you put this? Is it recent? Where are these cards? Let's get to, Can you repost this by... Oh, here, I found it. Okay, again, you are... I swear I have it in the instructions. You have to give me the text of the name. Because if you don't give me the text of the name, I can't look it up. And then I'm just scrolling through my entire Discord looking for your card. Well, it's harder for me to search by name. I want to... And by the way, if you guys submit, like, tons of things, searching you guys by name is going to be useless. Because it's going to pop up all your cards. Okay, we got Burgeoning Painter, a white 2 generic 1/1, a human advocate. It's got paint. It's gonna tap and pay white. And you choose one, create a 0/1, 0/4 wall colorless creature token with defender, 2 clue tokens, or sacrifice a non-token creature you control to search your library for a basic swamp, island, or plains and put onto the battlefield tapped. Her mind is her only limit. In the world of art, there is no limit. I think this is fine. Look very, very good. Okay, hold on. Palette Jam says, Olympic Thrower does die if he attacks. I checked the rules to be sure he would be poked before damage step. Oh, okay. Weird. Yeah, if you put them titles, you people do as I say around here. If I can't find your card, I'll just skip you. I will donate it to the freebie section. I'm warning you all, I'll donate it to the freebie section. Okay, we got Green Cheese with Dynify. Given your avatar, I'm really looking forward to this. Okay, we got Dynify. It is a green 2 generic enchantment. This spell costs 1 less to cast if it targets a creature you don't control. Enchant creature. Enchanted creature loses all abilities, becomes a green dino, and is a 6/6 trampler. Hold on. Actually, if it loses all abilities, doesn't also lose trample? Or is like, loses all... Or it just becomes, or do we have to word it in such a way like it becomes like this card and then that's it, right? I was hoping you would just scroll your Discord to see the cards as the person. Well, I look things up on my Discord. That's how it works around here. Either way, yeah, your Dynify card, definitely playable. I don't know if it's good, but you can make it work. Okay, we got now Bacon Catbug, a huge super chat. Cycle of 2 mana value instants. With an off-color kicker. Oh, I did this one already. Okay, let's do another one. Some Warhammer 40k shenanigans. You people love your Warhammer. I cannot relate. It's a green red 1/2 orc warrior squad 2, and it's got so an addition as an additional cost to cast the spell, you can pay 2 any number of times to replicate it, and that's it. Oh, wow! Battle cry when this creature attacks. That's a very long ability. Is that real? Each other attacking creature gets +1/+0 until end of turn. Oh, it's like real battle. Oh, I get it. It's just like regular battle cry, but you gave it like its own 40k flavor. The best means of attack is defense. Ah, the best means of attack is a really, really big one. Right, with lots of boys and dead big shooty things. And what you have? I have a feeling there's going to be more flavor text than actual card. We have a green, red... By the way, the last card, totally fine. We have a aura for 4 mana. Enchant creature. We all cramp Tokeva. Enchanted creature has tap. This creature fights target creature. And that's it. Excess damage is dealt to that creature's controller instead. Oh, it's like it has trample for fight. Activate only as a sorcery. Come back for another go. It's another, not another, another go. Escape for green, red, 2 generic. Exile 4 other cards from your graveyard. This also seems particularly okay. Nothing too broken. Daka, Daka, Daka for 4 mana. It's a sorcery. Cast the spell only if a creature you control dealt combat damage to a player this turn. Untap all creatures you control. After this phase, there is an additional combat phase. Enough, Daka? Enough means if you's got any more, then it's too much Daka, and you can never too much Daka. I have no idea what the hell any of that meant. I don't know the lore well enough, people. I don't know the lore. Corbinick, 1 hour behind the stream. Beer is technically a poison. Welcome, Corbinick. To the from the future talking to the past, Corbinick. Okay, we got Mech Boy Spanner. Red 2 generic 1/3 orc artificer. Custom gubbins. Mech Boy Spanner crews vehicles as though its power were 3 or greater. The red ones go faster. Whenever Mech Boy Spanner crews a vehicle, and that vehicle becomes red and gains haste and trample until end of turn. And lastly, we got a vehicle. We got the Morkanaut. It's a 6-mana 7/7 vehicle with first strike and menace. And cunning but brutal. Whenever Morkanaut becomes blocked, it deals 2 damage to target planeswalker or player it's attacking for each creature blocking it. And it's got crew 4. Yeah, red go faster. Somehow everything is faster when you red. Daka, daka, daka. Or is it this one? No, this one. This Mech Boy Spanner is the red go faster. Are players permanents in regards to that last counterspell? No. Players are not permanents. That is for sure. Majra, the last 5 cards of part 2 of the... what is it called? Eternity? Part 2... You mean part 1? I think you mean part 1. I don't think we did part 2. Glad I had the forethought to know what the hell you were talking about. Okay, we got, because we definitely didn't do this one. First 5 cards. Is there a part 2 to the Eternity? Last 5, oh no, this is the last 5 cards of part 1. Yeah, you're doing it very, very, very much out of order. Last 5 cards, okay, hold on. Okay, so I'll do this one. Gotta be an order here, Majra. Order, or I'm gonna get confused the hell out of what's going on here. You have so many cards. We got a red, blue, 1 generic arcane rebound. Return target creature to its owner's hand. Aether Mage's Malice deals 2 damage to target's owner. This card is busted! 3 mana with rebound, so I shock you, bounce a creature and has rebound? Absolutely not. This actually is insane. Control players would love this thing. Yeah, it's double Vapor Snake plus a shock attached to it, and it's free the second time around. No way. Did we do that? Yeah, we did the Fury one. Okay, Aether Magician's Shadow for a Dimir Red. It's a 2/2 Shade Spirit Warlock. Reach and flight? You mean flying? There is no such thing as flight. Whenever you cast an arcane spell, Aether Magician's Shadow deals 1 damage to any target. That is fine-ish, I guess. I don't know what flight means, though. Unless you mean just flying. Eternal Avenger, the black-black 2 generic... Sorry, so the black-black 2/2 Human Spirit Warlock. Death Touch, persist. Exile Eternal Avenger from your graveyard. Target spirit you control gains persist until end of turn. That is just weird. Okay, so you can exile it from the graveyard with no cost? You do exile it, so maybe it's okay, but it's possible that this is, like, really abusable. Eternal Book, a red, 1 generic equipment spirit. When Eternal Book enters the battlefield, attach it to target creature you control. Equipped creature is a spirit in addition to its other types and gets +2/+2 and has trample. This is a very weird card for red. Also, there's not a lot of red spirits out there. Flight means it's attacked as though it has flying. It's attack. Also, I mean, it's like can't be blocked except by flyers, is what you're meaning. Whenever an equipped creature deals combat damage to a player, exile the top card of your library. Until end of turn, you may play that card. Also equipped for 3 red. I think this is okay. Actually, this is a very interesting card. That actually might see some competitive play. We got the Eternal Apocalypse. It's for red, black, blue. It's also an arcane spell. Deals X damage to each creature in Planeswalker, where X is equal to the number of creatures on the battlefield and spirit and arcane cards in all graveyards. Big board wipe. And also smacks people. I'm getting through all your super chats. Don't worry, I did like another one of your super chats. We looked at, what did we just look at? There's no good order here. I'm trying to balance out how many you, Majra, and then everyone else get. So right now I'm going to go to Redco. We got the Seer Prost, the Egotistical. Whoops. Seer Prost. I'm going to get through all your super chats. All the super chats are going to get through today. It's all going to get through. Okay, we got, it was a different cycle? Did I screw that up? Okay, which was the right one? Let me know. Seer Prost, the Egotistical, 0 mana for a 1/1. Capybara Knight. Seer Prost is all colors, and it has flash. So it's an all color. It's like an all color gold 1/1 with flash. Oh, it's got flying, double strike, vigilance, reach, trample, death touch, vigilance, indestructible. How many times do you want to have vigilance here? Oh no, I only had it once. Haste, protection from all colors. Yeah, this is broken. Absolutely broken. Okay, next up. We'll do Redco's Fanatical Disunion? This card is one colorless instant. If red was spent to cast this spell, it deals 4 damage to target creature. Then exile the top card of your library. You may play it this turn. Okay, that's interesting. If blue is spent to cast the spell, draw a card, then tap the creature and put 2 stun counters on it. Also very interesting. Nice design. Also hard to cast because you need to have the colorless mana. You don't have colorless mana, you don't cast that card. That's for sure. You skipped the $10 suit. It was a different size. Well, what was it called? It was Bacon Cat Bug. What was it called? Hold on, I'm not skipping anything. Or where was... Hold on, where was your last $10 super chat? Oh my god, Majra. You're insane, Majra! You're insane! Majra is single-handedly gonna up the cost to this show. Or I'm gonna have like to say, you can only maximum offer like 20 cards per show. What was the name, Bacon Cat Bug? It was a different cycle of cards. That's why I had a different super chat and post name. Okay, but what was it? you're not giving me the name of the post. Or unless that is the name of the post. Nikachu, you skipped my thing! Pros keywords are all in flavor text, so they're not real keywords. Hence why he's so egotistical. Ah, is that how it is? Okay, next up we'll go... Well, while we wait for Bacon Catbug to give me the name of apparently the super chat that I skipped. Uh-oh. Okay, I thought something was freezing. We'll do a Bacon Catbug special here. Armor of the Contempt. Armor of Contempt. Contempt armor. There we go. Okay, I found it. Okay. This is a white instant. You get a deflection counter. If a player would be dealt damage while they have a deflection counter, remove all deflection counters from them instead. My armor is contempt. My sword is hatred. My shield is disgust. I'm gonna name a card. Nika, you just skip my card just for the shenanigans. Exactly. Okay, it was called a cycle of 2 mana value instants. Okay, let's look at hold on. First off, this thing, you get a deflect. If a player would be dealt damage while they have a deflection counter, remove all deflection counters from them instead. Excellent card. It's basically like a protection spell. Okay, so that one was a cycle of 2 mana value instants. With an off-color kicker. We did this one! Were you in the bathroom or something? Exile up to 1 target non-land permanent you own, then return it. Oh! Do you have the same arts and then you just change the words? And I got confused? Because this is a little bit different. It phases out instead. Okay. So we have, now you did the opposite. Oh, and this is blue. No, it's not quite the opposite. Okay, I think I understand. I thought I did the super chat already. Okay, Rena's Unraveling. It's a white 1 generic instant. Pay a blue 1 generic for a kicker. Exile up to 1 target non-land perm you own, then return it to the battlefield under its owner's control. But if the spell was kicked, target perm you don't control phases out. Yeah, that's unique. Use different arts on your cards. Completely confused me. Okay, next. Umuya's Bitterness. It's a blue 1 generic instant. Kicker of 2 mana. Counter target spell unless it's controlled pays 2. If it's kicked, counter target spell instead. If this spell was kicked, counter target spell instead? I don't understand. Counter target spell unless it's controlled pays 2. Shouldn't it just be counter target spell? So actually this isn't templated properly. Then its controller sacrifices a permanent they control with the greatest mana value among permanents they control. So I think instead of counter target spell instead, it's just counter target spell. It's a hard counter at 4 mana. Brexena's Resentment, black 1 generic instant. Kicker of 2 mana. Destroy target creature, you lose life equal to its mana value. If this spell was kicked, Brexena's Resentment deals damage equal to that creature's mana value to target opponent. Hold on, are we giving like counter spells to like every color? Oh no, so this is not a counter spell, this is destroy target creature. Okay, this is a lot better. That's a cool card. I think a lot of people would play that card. Rukaya's Grace. It's a 2 mana for 3 damage to any target. If a permanent dealt damage this way would die this turn, exile it. And if it was kicked, return target card from your graveyard to your hand. Also a very interesting card. That would see a lot of play. Like, you just buffed up a lot of, like, red mana spells. Burn would play this card. Okay, Gaia's Warding. It's a green 1 generic instant. Kicker of white 1 generic. Target creature gets +1/+1 for each basic land you control until end of turn. If the spell was kicked, that creature gains lifelink and first strike until end of turn. That is very fair. In fact, this is the crappiest card of all of them. This is Draft Chaff. Draft Chaff League. Oh my god. Okay. I need to set up some more music. We're gonna be in for a long show. Long show. It's gonna be a long show today, people. Okay, next let's go. Marv, I have no cards, so here's a freebie. Your streams are rad. Thank you so much, Marv. I appreciate it. And with that, I'm gonna give it to the freebie section. There we go. Super Bomb is lucky to get their card on the show. It's a blue one generic 3/1 bird warrior with morph for a blue one generic. When Penguin Soldier is turned face up, return up to 2 target creatures to their owner's hands. That's insane. And it's also a 3/1 for 2 mana. That's like an insanely large penguin. Okay. I will say... So it's like... So for 5 mana, we morph it, and then we pop it up. So it's like 5 mana, bounce 2 creatures, and you have a 3/1. I guess it's okay. Penguin, hold on, Penguin Soldier is a Yu-Gi-Oh card from one of the original starter decks. Oh my goodness. We got Yu-Gi-Oh cards bleeding in here. Okay, next up. Let's do another crazy Majra post. We've got the last 5 cards of part 2 of the Eternity. This is part 2 of the... Can you, like, also... Hold on, is it gonna look up this? Eternity. I'm just curious to know if Discord can look up... No, it doesn't know what this... Don't use special characters. I can't find them on Reddit. I can't find them on Discord. Part 2 of the... Oh, God. I can't find this thing. Hold on. Eternity. Can I look up Eternity? Nope. Part 2... of the... I don't know if you've posted this, Majra. Did you post this? It's not looking up part 2 of the Eternity. I don't know if you posted a name of this thing. You have part 1. Well, maybe part 1. I'll look up part 1. Maybe you have part 2 right below it. Part 2. Oh, it's not part 2 of. It's part 2 the... Majra, Majra, Majra. Okay, well, I figured it out. You gotta be specific. It's just like Reddit. You gotta be 100% specific. 100% specific. So this was... Was this the first 5 or the last 5? I know it's part 2. Well, I'm not... It's really hard for me. Can't you post these in, like... So the first cards from part 2. Yeah, these are all out of order. Okay, I'll do the last 5 because I think that's what the super chat was. So yeah, either Magician's Malice, or did I do that one? Reach Flights? We did this one. We did the last five. Okay, probably the first five cards from part two of the Eternity. Okay, these... Have you, like, are you, like, reposting these Super Chats over and over again? We did this one as well. Or maybe I am not clearing them. I hope you're not Super Chatting extra times, Majra. I already did that. Okay, good. Yeah, chaos ensues on this show. Chaos. Absolute chaos is happening here. Okay, let's look at the first five from part three then. Part three now. Okay, part... It's like part dot three of the Eternity. Okay, good. Okay, this is the first five cards. Okay, let's get rid of this. Cleaning up on my side. Yeah, scroll down. Part two is below. Okay, I found part two and apparently it was useless. I like this picture. We got a blue 2/2 elemental spirit wizard. Island walk persist. Whenever Ethernal Own Dine deals combat damage to player, draw a card. Love abilities like that. And whenever whenever exile Ethernal on Dine from your graveyard, target spirit gains island walk until end of turn. That is a cool design. Not broken and also very useful. Actually, do you know what? This card might be broken. A control deck might love this thing. And it's got persist. Do you know, I take it back. This actually is insane. This is actually broken. I think control decks would love this card. They'll just be like, turn two, Ethernal Undyne. Oh, you play a creature, kill it. Attack, draw a card. Oh, you try to kill my thing, it has persist. Actually, you have to get rid of persist off of this thing. Probably this is too broken with the persist. It can't have a two mana draw a card upon dealing damage, especially in blue. It's going to be like a little bit too much. Yeah, and the island walk is amazing. Okay, Eternal Sanctuary. It is a 10 mana legendary enchantment. Cost one less to cast for each spirit or arcane in your graveyard. Pay a blue, target spell gains rebound. Pay a black, target spell gains death touch. Pay a red, target spell gains wither. This is very fair, I think. 10 mana, you better get something amazing out of for 10 mana. Eternal Shadow Mage. It's a 2 mana 2/2 human spirit wizard with wither again. Hold on. Yeah, this is persist, not wither. Okay, arcane spells you control cost one less to cast. Also fine. I think we should make the arcane spells cheaper. We got to make them playable to some degree. Okay, next up is red. We have an Eternal Steel Dream. It's a 2/2 human spirit wizard with, again, persist. Whenever Eternal Steel Dream deals combat damage to a player, Fate Seal won that player. That is evil. That actually might be broken too. You may reveal the looked card if it's an instant or sorcery with mana value 2 or less. If you do, you may cast the revealed card though paying its mana cost. That's also probably pretty broken. Exile Ethereal Steel Dream from your graveyard deals 2 damage to any target. Snap busted. Get it out of here. No, you can't have that one. That's like way too many abilities. Wait, you want to shock things for 0 mana? No, that's terribly broken. Okay, we have the Eternal Ultimatum. It's a red, black, blue, arcane. Exile up to 3 instant or sorceries from each graveyard and cast them without paying their mana cost. Exile Ethereal Ultimatum. That I can get behind. That's pretty cool. I think it's going to be fine. It's probably going to do something huge. Like, you're going to self-mill yourself, play this thing. But you know what? For 7 mana, you better do something like that. I don't think Fate Chill should be red. I don't think you should get that much stuff for 2 mana. That's like way too much in my opinion. Way too much. Okay, next up. Let's take something from Steve Cooper. Steve Cooper got a simple $2 super chat here. Bolt a bird on the Discord, third image. Bolt the Bird. It is a 3 mana, 3/2 bird elemental, haste flying. Whenever a creature with mana ability and opponent controls enters the battlefield, Bolt the Bird deals 3 damage to that creature. No way. Whenever a creature with a mana ability enters the battlefield, it just basically die. Tap, add 1 mana of any color. Also, isn't it also a mana ability? But it only affects the opponent's creatures. Red, sacrifice Bolt the Bird. Bolt the Bird deals 3 damage to any target. I think this is busted. It's way, way too busted. 2 images down? Wait, how many did you make? It's all the same, isn't it? Another creature. Sacrifice Bolt the Bird. Bolt the Bird deals 3 damage to any target. Whenever creature with mana ability and opponent controls, it's the same thing. Look, if you can always delete the other ones. I didn't know that there were several of them posted here. Anyway, I think it's busted. The fact that it just automatically shoots mana, it automatically kills mana dorks. Maybe at this point it's too late in the game at 3 mana, but still, like, this is insanely oppressive. Yeah, okay, what's the point of playing mana dorks anymore when it's just gonna bolt them to death? I mean, it'd be fine if it, like, it sacrifices itself, but this static ability is too much. And it's a haste flying creature, and it adds mana. This is way too strong. No chance. Okay, we got Ty Free, the legendary RMS Titanic. Artifact. Look up Titanic. Oh, did you post on Reddit?
We don't do that anymore around here. We use the Discord.
Legendary RMS Titanic. Okay, I did find it. Thank you for paying a little bit more than usual, so I went out of my way to go find this thing. Why is that Phyrexian mana? Why does that have Phyrexian mana? That's completely wild. Okay, we have a Phyrexian 4 generic ship. Do I have a ship sound effect? Not really. Oh no, I do have a ship sound effect. Okay, spell costs 1 less to cast for each human you control. Why? Okay, when RMS and it's got fading 4. Well, I like that flavor though. When RMS Titanic enters the battlefield, create 2/2 human creature tokens with lifelink and haste. When RMS Titanic is put into your graveyard, sacrifice target human you control. If you do, another target human you control gains indestructible until end of turn. That I don't understand. Why would anything be indestructible? They're all vulnerable. They all almost died. Some people went down with the ship. Some people had a lifeboat. Because the loss of the Titanic, it's all about the flavor. I just don't understand why something is indestructible. I'll tell you one thing that's not indestructible. It was the RMS Titanic. And now it gets to lay at the bottom of the ocean with the RMS... what's it called? What was that submarine? Sea... Ocean Gate. The Ocean Gate submarine. Anyway, I guess this thing is fine. Don't we have a Titanic card from Doctor Who? Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Okay, next super chat. What do we got here? Let's take one from Platonic Liquid. Thank you very much, Platonic Liquid. Be mine! For Valentine, it's Valentine's Day today. Be mine. Okay, we have a red 1 generic instant. Gain control of target creature with total power and toughness 5 or less until end of turn. Well, you will be mine. Untap that creature. It gains haste. Its owner creates a food token. The road to a lot of people's heart is usually through their stomach. Life magic is like a box of chocolates. You don't know what you're gonna. You don't know what hand you're gonna draw. Okay, next up, let's chain through some of these smaller ones. This, by the way, is completely fine. Sounds great. Let's go with Bacon Cat Bugs. Fell Transformation, Shadowverse Adept. We have more than one Shadowverse person here. Fell Transformation. It is a black sorcery. As additional cost to cast this spell, pay 1 life. 1 life! As if that matters at all. Destroy target creature with toughness 4 or less. Its controller creates a 1/1 black bat creature token with flying. If you target a creature you control, put a +1/+1 counter on that token. Looks beautiful. We'll get another one through you, Bacon Cat Bug. Railing. Arcane Arbiter. We've got here, it is a black Orzhov White 2 generic 4 loyalty Raylene. The first spell players cast each turn costs 2 more to cast. That is insane. That is Ireo power level broken. So basically, you're telling everyone, like, everything costs two more to cast. And probably the first thing that they play is going to tap them out. Plus one, target creature. Sorry, create a 1/1 black and white bird spirit creature token with flying and lifelink. Minus one, you may cast target non-land permanent card in a graveyard until end of turn. Add mana of any type can be spent to cast the spell. It costs two less to cast. What? So you can cast target non-land permanent card in a graveyard until end of turn. So basically, it costs two less. You taxed everyone by two, but now you're giving yourself a discount by two. Minus seven, each non-land permanent card in your graveyard gains escape zero until end of turn. I think this is very annoying to play against, but it's probably sort of fair. How does anyone feel about getting their first spell taxed every single turn? It's impossible to post your card. You can post your... What, are you banned from Discord? You just make another Discord account. Then, of all people, did all of Discord ban you or something? Next up, we go with Red Co. Rediscover. Just like how people rediscover magic. They quit, they come back, they quit, they come back. We got... Oh, look at this. We got a 3-mana hybrid card. It's all banned. Sorcerer, reveal the top card of your library. If it's a land, you can put it onto the battlefield tapped. If it's a creature card, you may put it into your hand. If it's a non-creature, non-land card, you may mill a card. Oh, that is cool. That's a very neat, like, card draw spell. So you reveal it. If it's land, it's ramp. But if it's, like, a creature, its value, it goes into your hand. And if it's anything else, you're allowed to basically, like, surveil it into the graveyard. It's like super surveil. Or is it like a worse surveil? Now I'm thinking, okay, so it's the difference between this and like consider is that you can put lands into play. That's the benefit out of this. Escape zero is insane. Yeah, but it's an ultimate. It was an ultimate, people. It should be ultimately very, very good. Next up, we've got protection from good and evil from Redco. Protection from good and evil. Can't find it. Protection. Oh, wait, it's called. Oh, sorry. You're right. I'm an idiot. It's protection from evil and good. That's not the combination I thought it would be spelled, but finally, it's evil and good, not good and evil. We have an Orzhov enchantment, Divine Aura. It enchants creatures. Enchanted creature has protection from angels, archons, demons, devils, dragons, elementals, fairies, horrors, skeletons, and zombies. I have no idea who hurt you, Redco, but that is totally fine. 100% okay with me. Okay, Bacon Catbug, Sword of Questing and Beef. What the hell? Sword of Questing and Beasts? That's such a bizarre name. Okay, the Sword of Questing and Beasts! 3-mana equipment. Equip creature has Vigilance, Death Touch, and Haste. Equip creature can't be blocked by creature with power 2 or less. Combat damage that would be dealt by equipped creature can't be prevented. Equipped creature deals combat damage to an opponent. It deals that much damage to our player or planeswalker that player controls. Honestly, I feel like this is a lot of words. This thing does a lot. It feels like it just does too much. This is a literal spell from D&D. It probably should cost a little bit more. I mean, maybe it's okay. It doesn't buff up the creature. The creature technically doesn't have power and, like, doesn't get any, like, protection. It's just questing beast. Oh, is it? Vigilance, Death Touch. You're right. It's the Sword of Questing and Beasts. Okay, I missed that one. You know what? That just went, whoosh, flew right over my head. It's the Sword of Questing Beast, really. It's actually weaker than Questing Beast. The combat damage part is restricted. Absolutely. It's like, I'm accusing this card of being word salad when this card already exists on a creature. All it has is like an extra equip of two, and then that's it. Okay. Mantra, the last five cards from part three of the Affinity. Okay, what's the last five card? We did one, two, three, four, five, so we didn't do this one. This looks like some sort of Sailor Moon wand. Moon Power! Blue, blue, one generic. Okay, so it's an ethereal wand for three mana. It's an equipment spirit. When ethereal wand enters the battlefield, attach it to target creature you control. Equipped creature is a wizard in addition to its other types and gets plus two and has flying. Whenever you cast an arcane spell, create a sorcery roll. I don't even know what a sorcerer roll is. Token is attached to target creature you control and you can equip for three. I hope it's not broken. I don't know what a sorcerer roll is though. Ethereal Witch, two mana, 1/1. Pro white. Creatures your opponents control can't have +1/+1 counters put on them. A banger card! Finally, a hate piece to the goddamn proliferate decks. I think there's a lot of people that would want something like this. Plus, you gave it a little bit of protection from white, and it's really cheap to get into play. That's a banger. There should actually be more cards that prevent crap like this. Everyone hates your opponent. Creatures your opponents control can't have +1/+1. You could even put, like, players can't get counters either. So you prevent infect as well. Eternity, Memories of Light Waves, 6 mana, sorcery. Exile each non-land permanent and put a time counter on them. Oh god. Equal the number of cards exiled this way. If they don't have suspend, they gain suspend. Hold on, isn't this terrible? Isn't this just upheaval? Exile each non-land permanent. Oh, it's non-lands, okay. That's what balances it out. Eternity's Echoes. Is it? It's an instant arcane. Copy target arcane spell. You may choose new targets for the copy. That's also totally fine. And Eternity's Magister. 2 mana for a 2/2 human wizard. Whenever you cast your first arcane spell each turn, scry one, then draw a card. That could be broken. That's like worse than, what's it called? It has a very similar feel to like Baral. Except, like, if you untap with this, I mean, you're just gonna, like, chain, like, so much value together. Oh, no, it's only the first. Okay, that's fine. It's only the first. Yeah, first, though. Halopli is reading the cards. Yeah, I think that's fine. So the rolls are singular auras with specific abilities. A creature can have a one roll aura. Yeah, but I don't know what a sorcery roll is. The sorcery roll. Okay, let's look at Steve Cooper donated for Huntroid wants Grim Reaper on the Discord. Grim Reaper. There you go, Huntroid. It's probably broken. Okay, it's a black, two generic, 3/4 zombie with a gigantic eminence ability. Whenever another creature you control dies, you get an experience counter. At the beginning of your upkeep, create X22 zombie creature tokens equal to the number of experience counters you have. At the beginning of your end step, choose target creature card in your graveyard. If that card's mana value is less than or equal to the number of experience counters you have, return it to the battlefield. Otherwise, put it into your hand. This thing's just broken. Right? So you just sack stuff that you have, get counters, and then at the beginning of your upkeep, you make a ton of zombies. And it's just compounds it's insane. Life is not the end, and death is just the beginning. This is outrageously broken. Okay, next up, let's look at Tavishel. Thank you very much, Tavishel. And thanks, King Ginger. Sorry, not King Ginger. Sorry, Madra, for doing some editing. Hopefully I'll find them. It shouldn't be a problem. Okay, we got Painful Remembrance. Sorry, Remembrance. Painful Remembrance and Blissful Oblivion. It's green, black, sorcery, reciprocate. When you cast the spell, if it targets an opponent, you may copy it. If you do, that copy must target you. Oh, God. Oh, hence why it's called Reciprocate. Target player returns a card of your choice from their graveyard to their hand. They lose life equal to half that card's mana value rounded up. But this is weird. Isn't it just like target player? You have to target a player. So it should just be you and target player get to do this, right? When you cast the spell, if it targets an opponent, you may copy it. I guess the difference is you have to target someone that is targetable. That's the only like weird thing with this card. The show's long. Must be making bank on your infinite. I know this is an infinite money machine. It's a big it's a infinite money printer thing. Okay, Majra, first five. First five cards, part four. Okay, part four of the eternity. This is wild. Okay, we got Archivist of Eternity. It's a blue 2 generic 2/3 human spirit. Flash, ward 2, maximum hand size increased by 7. Beginning of each upkeep. If you have less than 3 cards in hand, you draw a card. Okay, that last part's broken, I think. I think it's a little too much. So it's 3 mana, you can play with Flash. At the beginning of each upkeep, you draw cards? No, that's... If you get rid of that last sentence, fair and fine. It's gotta be way more mana for that ability. Consecrated Sphinx, for crying out loud, is like 6 mana. Bite of the Night, it is a black 2 generic instant. Choose one, target creature gets -4/-4 until end of turn. Or remove four counters from target permanent. The target would die this turn, exile it instead. That is a clunky removal spell that is totally fine on my radar. Burn Dream of Eternity. 3 mana for a 2/2 human spirit warlock. Flying Withered Persist. Whenever an opponent draws a card and it deals 1 damage to each opponent. Great card. We gotta speed up this game. You wanna draw cards? Well, you're gonna face the pain. We got the Burning Strike, a red 2 generic instant. The spell costs 1 less to cast if you control a spirit. Burning Strike deals 3 damage to any target. Also very fair. The first one is completely busted. There's no cockroaches in my house, and that's final. I don't know how this conversation came up, but I know how it ended. Converse with the Knight, a 4 mana instant arcane spell. Scry 2, then draw 2 cards. Many cards of that design. 4 mana, scry 2, draw 2. What else does this do? If Converse of the Knight was cast from anywhere other than your hand, scry 4, then draw 4 cards. This says, so if you flash it back. Or foretell it. You have a bit of a foretelling thing going on here. Dang, I was hoping to make one more Valentine's card. Well, you still have time there. You still have time. Yeah, vote squirrels. See you later, toads. All right, next up, we've got a look at, holy crap. Okay, Palajam. You're like the second last person remaining. Half a genius. Half. I gotta use them hyphens, huh? Or these dashes. Nope. Half a... Oh, sorry. It's Janitus. Oh. What? It's 5 mana for a 5/5 Hydra avatar. Protection from half the things. An opponent may ask you at any time if half a Janitus has protection from something that wasn't asked this game and reveal a card that applies to that protection from their hand. If you answer yes, your next answer must be no. Keep note of all the protection and a half a Janitus has or does not have. Oh god, if half a Janitus would be put into a graveyard from anywhere, reveal half a Janitus and shuffle it into its owner's library instead. This card doesn't make any sense. It makes sense, but it's going to be absolute pain to keep track of. When I have to, okay, so I'm going to say no. Then I say yes, then I say no, and I have to keep track of every single stupid permanent. My mountain! Do you have protection from my mountain? No. Alright, and then the next spring you have to say yes to. Yeah, it only makes half sense around here. Only half sense. This is my new commander, sorry. It is silver bordered for a reason. It is silver bordered. Okay. It's time for the Majra Show. Okay, we got the last 5 cards from part 4 of the Eternity. Okay, it's time for the Majra Show for the next, I don't know, next 30 minutes or something. Okay, hold on, part 4 of the Eternity. I'm glad. Oh, it wasn't even, didn't even have a dot. Okay, hold on. The last 5 cards, right? Dawn Consultation. We got a blue 2 generic arcane sorcery. Draw 2 cards. Sure. So you're just trying to make arcane good. Because it never was. The Delinquents of Eternity. We have, is it 1 generic for a star 3 flash wither persist creature? Why does everything have flash? Its power is equal to the number of spirits in arcane in all graveyard. Probably that's fine. It's probably fair. It's like playing a bunch of arcane cards in your deck is like really clunky. Dive into the Eternity. Blue 1 generic. Scry 3. You may reveal any number of arcane among the cards you look, then put them into your hand, then draw a card. I hope that's not broken. Palajam super happy. Very proud of themselves for that last half a genesis. Divination Classroom for 3 mana. It's got flash, enters the battlefield, surveil 2, then draw 2 cards. That is already getting broken, actually. You know, the divination is like sorcery speed for a reason. This is worse. This has surveil. Sacrifice Divination Classroom. Reveal an instant or sorcery card from your hand. This card gains splice onto arcane. Exile 3 cards from your graveyard until end of turn. I think this card is a bit pushed. I'm not sure, but I think it is. It's basically 3 mana, draw 2 at instant speed. There's not a whole lot of cards that do that. Now, there are some. And this has also extra abilities attached. It's close. It's very, very close. So is today just Majra Waifu Chaos Day for the rest of the show? Unless someone else super chats, correct. Come for the custom card, stay for the waifus. Malphus Classroom. 3 mana enchantment with flash enters the battlefield. You may have it deal X damage to any target where X is equal to the number of spells that have been cast this turn. Sacrifice Malphus Classroom. Reveal an instant or sorcery card from your hand. This card gains splice onto arcane. Target opponent gains 3 life until end of turn. Whatever around here. Okay, next Majra super chat. This one is the first 5 cards from part 5. It's actually convenient going through all your super chats all at once. One with Eternity. It's a black instant. Prevent all damage that would be dealt this turn. This is literally just fog. In the arcane form, I hope I understand arcane well enough that this card isn't broken. Because you have a lot of arcane spells, but you don't have a lot of splice onto arcane spells. And I don't know how like having like a fog being played every single turn is gonna work out. Huntroid, huge fan of the waifus. Huge fan. We have a red, blue, 1 generic instant arcane. Shuffle target spell or permanent into its owner's library, then reveal the top of their library. If the revealed card is the same card type as the target, they may cast it without paying its mana cost. Shuffle target spell or permanent into its owner's library. If the revealed card is the same card type as the target, they may cast it. That's actually super fair. So you basically, it's like a removal spell, but you also give them a chance of like getting another spell back out of it. Path to Eternity. It's a 3 mana enchantment. Flash. Why are you giving all these enchantments flash? I mean, I know we have a lot of flash enchantments in the game, but it usually makes cards more broken than they should be. When Path to the Eternity enters the battlefield, create 2 tapped treasure tokens. Black, 2 generic. So it only costs 1 mana. Black, 2 generic, sacrifice Path to the Eternity, surveil 2, then draw a card. This is literally like a ramp spell. It's like 3 mana, just ramp. Oh, you don't do anything? Okay, I'll ramp 2, thank you very much. And if you blink this thing, you get like even more ramp cards. I think this card dangers. Okay, Promenade in the Eternity. It's a blue 3 generic. Draw a card for each spirit you control. Oh, I think spirit players would love this card. Create a sorcerer roll token attached to each wizard and warlock you control. So that's fair and fine. And Refusal of the Eternity. It's a black, blue, red, instant arcane. Counter target non-arcane spell, then copy it. You may choose new targets for the copy. Let's do that. So we just went through the first half, let's do the second half at the same time. The last five cards of the part five of the Eternity. The waifu cards. Return to the Eternity. It's a 3-mana instant arcane. Return target non-land permanent to its owner's hand. Then that player discards a card. Return target non-land card. I think that a card like this already exists. But it's just not arcane, that's all. Shine Dream of the Eternity. 3-mana 2-2. Flying Persist and Wither. Whenever you cast an arcane spell, create a 0-1 colorless star spirit creature token with flying. Star tokens you control have when this creature dies, gain 1 life. Pretty sure these are not broken. The Sigil of Eternity. It's a 4-mana enchantment. If Sigil of the Eternity is in your opening hand, you may begin the game with it on the battlefield. You may cast arcane spells as though they had flash, and whenever you cast your first arcane spell each turn, Sigil of Eternity deals 2 damage to any target. Hold on, maybe cast your first spell. First arcane spell. Maybe cast arcane spells as though they had flash. I think this is... If it's in your opening hand, it can begin on the battlefield. That would... This breaks the rest of the cards. It's like this... I swear, this card actually probably breaks the rest of, like, everything. And like every single time you play an arcane spell, you draw, like, wait, are you drawing a card? Your first arcane spell, it deals 2 damage to any target. So they had flash. Oh no, this doesn't say you draw a card for each card that you play. I don't know about this one. It deals 2 damage to any target. Maybe it's okay. It's close. It's like that one could be very dangerous. Song of Eternity, 6-mana, arcane. Spell costs 2 less to cast This spell costs 2 less to cast. Gain Cascade if a spirit died this turn. What the hell? Song of Eternity deals damage equal to the number of spirit or arcane in your graveyard to any target. You gain that much life? I don't know. I don't even know what this does, but it sounds dangerous. If the spell you cast by the Cascade of Song of Eternity is an arcane, that spell gains Cascade. This sounds dangerous to me. I know it's very expensive, but giving a bunch of stuff Cascade is very, very dangerous. Whatever, already have blue ley line that gives flash to everything. That's true. Sorcery Classroom. It is a, is it one generic enchantment with flash? Enters the battlefield, draw a card, then, hold on. When Sorcery Classroom enters the battlefield, draw a card, then instant and sorcery costs 1 less to cast until end of turn. Sacrifice it, reveal an instant or sorcery from your hand. This card gains splice onto arcane until end of turn. That is probably okay. Probably, but not guaranteed. Okay, some other people super chat, so let's get to them. Let's do a palette jam. Palette jam! Fractal Locus. Squeezing this math. Hold on. Lotus. Squeezing the math flower into the tight budget for Valentine's. Post has some number explanation on it to avoid live mathing. In another math card, probably broken in half in many ways, but I love figuring out the numbers involved. Some people love numbers out there. It's basically channel, but you're only allowed to pay exactly 1, 3, 7, 15, 31, 36. Oh god. Okay, Fractal Lotus, 5-mana. Enters the battlefield, you lose 1 life and add 1 mana of any color. Tap, sack, Fractal Lotus you control. Create 2 token copies of Fractal Lotus for each Fractal Lotus sacrifice this way. When it enters the battlefield, you lose 1 life and add 1 mana of any color. Sack it. It doesn't enter the battlefield tapped. I don't get it. So tap, sacrifice each Fractal Lotus you control, create 2 tokens. Why are you only allowed to have pay 1, 3, 7? Or is this the amount of life you keep burning as you keep splitting them in half? But it's totally busted. It's definitely busted. It's completely broken in half. It's completely unplayable. Because you pay a lot of life, but you have no problem getting that much mana. You get 1 mana of any color! Sure, pay 15 life, it's not a problem. There are some people out there who will pay 15 life all day and all night. You have to sack all of them. That's fine. They would love to do it. It's just you get the man. You get the mana when enters the battlefield, right? That's all you need to do. That isn't Fractal Kindred. 0 out of 10. Oh well. Okay. Okay. Next up, Majra with the first 5 cards. The first 5 cards from the last part of the Eternity. That's great. Part 6. We'll probably just bang out both of these. The first 5 cards, then the last 5 cards. Oh, you don't have 5 cards? You only have 8 cards here, Majra? What happened? You run out of creativity? I'm just kidding. Soul's Immolation. It's a red 2-generic arcane. Deals 4 damage to target creature or planeswalker. If the target dies, you exile it. We got the Eternity. How many Eternities do we have? I swear we've gone to the Eternity a million times. This is now the Eternity with a weird 4 mana casting cost. When you cast your first arcane spell each turn, copy it. You may choose new targets for the copy. I feel like this should cost more for that ability. Whenever you cast your first arcane spell from anywhere other than your hand this turn, you may copy it twice. You choose new targets for the copy. I could be wrong, but this card could be busted in your deck. It's 4 mana. Yeah, it's 4 mana. That's not a lot of mana, Majra. That's actually very, very little mana, if you ask me. Expensive, but arcane. The arcane spells aren't that expensive. These arcane spells are expensive. I guess this is okay. You're just doubling the spell. I could be totally wrong. Doesn't this trigger itself? It might. Verge of the Eternity. Oh, we got land. I love your land cycles, Majra. Make more lands. We have tap, add a colorless, pay 2, tap, sacrifice it, search your library for an island or swamp card, put on the battlefield, tap, then shuffle. This is actually, it's just a fetch land. It's an expensive fetch land, so it's very fair. I don't know the advantage of playing that card. Wave of Fright. Black, black, 1 generic sorcery. Rebound. Costs 1 less to cast if you control a spirit or creature with flying. Put a -1/-1 counter on each creature your opponents control. When Wave of Fright is cast from anywhere other than your hand, copy it. It also has flashback of 4 mana. So you get like 2 copies. Cute picture, too. It's like a weird board wipe, sort of. And Arjuna, Eternal Archer. It's a 2/3 human spirit. Persist, wither, reach whenever you cast an arcane spell. Arjuna deals 1 damage to any target. Threshold, as long as 7 more. Threshold? You're bringing Threshold into the mix all of a sudden. As long as 7 or more cards are in your graveyard, if a source you control would deal damage to an opponent or permanent opponent controls, it deals that much damage. +2 instead. So basically turns Lightning Bolt. If you have 7 cards in the graveyard, Lightning Bolts turn into like lightning blasts. Or does it fetch 2 lands? Did I miss that part? For an island card and a swamp card and put onto the battlefield. It's like a super fetch land. Oh. So under the battlefield tap, just adds colorless. Then you have to pay 3 mana to get 2. You sack 1. So it's a weird ramp card. I like this card. I think it's cool. I still think it's cool. Okay, let's do the second half. Let's bang out the second half here. Last 3 cards. Last 3 it is. What a series this was. Daka. It's like literally the Daka. 4 mana, 3/2. Human Spirit Shaman. Persist, First Strike, Ward, pay 3 life. Whenever you cast or copy an arcane spell, each opponent loses 1 life and you gain 1 life. Whenever a creature enters the battlefield from your graveyard, choose one that have not been chosen this turn. Daka deals 2 damage to any target. Draw a card, then lose 1 life. Or put a finality counter on target creature. I actually think, sometimes, you know, now I think about it, it'd be so hard to build a deck around these cards. Because you want the payoffs for your arcane spells, but you also need to fill your deck up with enough arcane spells that it would even do anything in the first place. If you know what I mean. Doesn't Arjuna trigger itself when dealing damage? It might! Oh, does it break? Where's Arjuna? As long as 7 cards, if a source you control would deal damage to an opponent or a permanent opponent controls, it deals that much damage, +2. If you cast an arcane, deal 1 damage to any target. Well, I mean, It'll deal more damage. What do you mean, like, it triggers itself? Whenever you cast an arcane or spell, Arjuna deals one damage to any target. Source you control deal damage to an opponent or is a permanent opponent controls it deals. It just deals that much damage plus two. So it just deals more damage. It's not like trigger, oh, deal another two damage as a trigger. It's just like if I deal one damage, instead it does three. So I don't think it's different. Did we do this one? Yeah, this one is okay. And then the world egg. I guess that's how the world was created. It came from an egg. The seven mana. Kindred legendary artifact, Eldrazi egg. What? Why are we all of a sudden putting, like, Eldrazi in this lore? You cast your first spell each turn for each color's mana symbol in the mana cost. You create, what, white? Create a 1-1 color shard creature with changeling. Blue, draw a card. Black, surveil 3. Red, deals 2 damage to any target. Green, create a treasure token. And the world egg is put into a graveyard from anywhere. Shuffle into its owner's library. Have fun. For 7 mana, why not? Okay, who else? We got David here. Welcome, David. I won't let you wait through everyone. You get to get pushed right to the front of the line here. Relieve of command. Relieve of... Did you post on Reddit? Gotta post on Discord. I will forgive you. How do we squeeze this thing here? Okay, we got a 5 mana sorcery. Use only colored mana to cast this spell. You don't say. Okay, activate only if there are no cards in your command zone. Search your library for a legendary creature with the same color identity as your commander. Oh, that's interesting. Put that card in your command zone. It is now your commander for the rest of the game. Commanders, when this card was played, is no longer your commander. Banger card. I think that's really cool. I think that we should have more abilities to turn other creatures in our deck into the commander for the rest of the game. Skip? You skipped? Did I skip somebody? Hold on. Okay, let's go back. Part 6. Who did I skip here? Oh, I thought this was the same guy. I thought this was the same guy as this. Because they all have the... You know, Majra, they all have the same damn abilities. They all have Vigilant. They all have Persist. A lot of them have First Strike and Persist and Wither. Okay, whenever... For 6 mana... whenever you cast an arcane or spirit spell, you may choose one that hasn't been chosen this turn. Create 2 treasure tokens, put 2 -1/-1 counters on target creature, or you draw 2 cards. Hold on. I just like the cat. So whenever you cast an arcane or something. Yeah, this is fine. Only because it's 6 mana, so you better get some payoff for this damn thing. We have to go back. We have to do a redo. We have to do a retake. Okay, let's get one from Bacon Catbug. Inspired by Tyban 3-1's Cycle of Lands. What is this called? It's called Inspired by... added art, made them modal so they can be common rarity, allied color, draft fixing, non-artifact, and added a tap cost to the clue land. I don't know what any of that means, but thank you very much for the super chat. So what are these? It's a wheat field. It's a plains. So it's a double-sided land that you can search for. Enters the battlefield tapped. Sacrifice wheat field. You gain 3 life. Hold on, let's see. Can I shift this thing to the side? Mysterious Lake enters the battlefield tapped. Pay 2, tap, sacrifice it, draw a card. That actually is really strong. I think being able to sack your lands at will for no downside... That second half is insane. The gain life thing is not so bad. I could be wrong. Maybe they're all fair. Oh, you can change the combinations all you want. Okay, so the blue one, we saw the blue one. So the black side is Gruesome Crypt, enters the battlefield tap, pay 1 tap, discard a card, sacrifice Gruesome Crypt to draw a card. That is more fair. It's like cycling in some way. You have to actually exchange this with another card. Then we got the Gilded Cliff. Enters the battlefield tapped. And you can sack it to add 1 mana of any color. Why don't... Oh, so you want one mana. That is very fair, because you could just tap it to add one mana every single turn, unless you desperately need that mana fixing. And then we have the green one. Worn Path. Enters the battlefield tap. Pay one, tap, sacrifice Worn Path. Target creature you control explores. Activate only as a sorcery. I think all of them are fair except the blue one. This blue one is nuts. Just pay two, tap, sack it, and draw a card. Can only search for one side. That actually is a good thing. You crack, whatever. That's totally fine. You just crack and go find the one that you want. In my opinion, any land that enters tapped is very fair. You know what? In a world of fetch lands, that is not true whatsoever. In the land of the fetch. Okay, next up we've got Platonic Liquid. Till death do us part. Hold on, maybe I should have... Oh, that's not really a good... Till death do us part. Till death do us part. Give a proper super chat sound effect. Can I find this thing? Till, T-I-L, it's three tills. Okay, I found it. They look like they're completely long dead. They were dead like years ago. It's a black 2 generic aura, enchant creature. When Till Death to Us Part enters the battlefield, if it's not a token, create a token copy attached to another target creature. When enchanted creature dies or Till Death to Us Part would leave the battlefield, destroy all creatures. Oh God. Enchanted by permanence till named till death do us part. Hold on. When death enters the battlefield, if it's not a token, create a token copy. Oh, I see. So you create a token copy and they go down together. Very interesting. Unless they're all combinations printed at common. Or you're talking about the, unless they were all combinations printed at common for a 24 land cycle. Oh, God. Talking about this last one. When enchanted creature dies or till death to us part would leave the battlefield, destroy all creatures enchanted by permanence named. It's only... Hold on. In the battlefield, if it's not a token, create a token copy attached to another... Oh, I get it. Okay. So till death to us part, it's an aura. It enters the battlefield, you make a copy and you put it on another creature. And if one of them dies, what, they both die? Yeah, it leaves it. How very romantic that is. Is that romantic to some people? When we die, we go down together. Okay, next up, we've got... Let's get one from Bacon Catbug. Final offer. Take it or leave it. Black, black instant. Cast the spell only during your draw step. Exile your hand face down. Put those cards into your hand at the beginning of your next upkeep step. That is weird, so you have to play this on your turn. Return each card in your graveyard to your hand. What? Exile your hand at the beginning of the next end step. Exile final offer. This card seems insane. Okay, we exile my hand face down. It could be nothing. Put those cards into your hand at the beginning of your next upkeep step. So like next turn. Return each card in your graveyard to your hand. Exile your hand at the beginning of the next end step. This card, this seems... It's like basically Yawgmoth's Will, right? But it's cheaper. It's just cheaper Yawgmoth's Will. And by the way, the cards that we play go back to the graveyard anyway. This has got to be BS. King George, you're a huge fan of the art. I think this is broken. I mean, maybe not for Commander. But it would be for one-on-one magic, that's for sure. Oh, you got some cards. Luke showed up. Oh my god, is this going to be like a five-hour show or something? Some re-zero cards on Discord. From Skywalker. All right, let's look at Betagiz Romani Conti. I probably didn't pronounce that properly. It's a black-black 3 generic 3/3 human shaman with menace. For double Phyrexian, deal 1 damage to target creature. We pay 4 life to... We basically deal 4 damage to ourselves to deal 1 damage to someone else. or a, to target creature attacking you or blocking a creature you control. Betelgeuse can block an additional 7 creatures? Don't understand the flavor of that. When Betelgeuse Romanticanti dies, another creature you control becomes a copy of it. That is just weird. I'll allow it! But hold on, doesn't that mean like you can like just basically infinitely block your opponent's creatures? So like it dies. It's not even a big creature, to be honest. So as long as you have one creature in play, you can infinitely block stuff. I have no idea if that's going to be fine or fun or whatever. Was it literally Beetlejuice? Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice! Is this anime Beetlejuice? Next up, we've got Sirius Romanticanti. It's a 5-mana 3/3 human elf cultist. When a source an opponent controls deals damage to Sirius, deal that much damage to all creatures. Oh god. You hit me, we hit everybody. When a source an opponent controls destroys Sirius Romanti, destroy all creatures. Oh my goodness. It's probably fair though. You blow me up, we all blow up. Lay Baton Kaitos. Blue, black, red for a 3/3 human cultist. Pay red. Put an eclipse counter on target creature you control. Or creature Lay Baton Kaitos dealt damage to this turn. For a blue and a black, like Baton Kaitos, gains all abilities. Target creature with an eclipse counter on it and has and that creature loses all abilities. Tap that creature. It does not untap as long as it has an eclipse counter on it. What? Okay, gains all abilities. Target creature with an eclipse counter has and that creature. So I absorb the abilities. So basically, we have all the abilities, and that thing lost all the abilities. We tap it, and it doesn't untap as long as an eclipse counter is on it. That sounds almost broken. Hold on, put an eclipse counter on target creature you control, or creature... Oh, it has to be a creature you control. Totally fair. Basically, almost punishing yourself. Okay, we got Sphinx, the undead catalyst. It is a 6-mana 3/3 elf wizard with flying. Whenever a non-token creature you control dies, create a token that's a copy of that creature with decayed. Oh my goodness. And we also have Sultai 2 generic. Create a token copy of target creature in a graveyard with decayed. Also pretty cool. All right, we got Roswell, L. Mathers. It's got Wooburg abilities. It's a Wooburg 1 generic 5/5 human wizard. It's got flying. And for a red, it deals 1 damage to any target. Oh my god. So what, with infinite red mana, you just kill everybody? That first ability might be broken. That's worse than fire breathing. What can't this do? It's got scry 1 for a blue. That probably is okay, but it's really strong. Pay a black. Target creature gets -2/-0 until end of turn. That's fine. Pay a white. Target creature gets +2/+1/+1. Why are we giving target creatures? This thing is like a god. It can do anything. With enough mana, it does whatever it wants. It can affect my creatures, can affect your creatures, it can affect any creatures. Pay a green, create a 0/1 green wall token with shroud. We can make like infinite walls, sacrifice at the beginning of the next end step. This card's broken. Nope. The first four cards, bangers. This last one, a little OP. Yeah, you know what, this is a little OP, even for a custom card show. This one seems like Zakama. When it enters the field, people tend to cry. Exactly. People tend to cry. Okay, let's get to another Majra special. Now that you've seen the entire Eternity, here's the last card from the previous deck. First clue. Sadanel. Oh, is this like, is this one card? Unbelievable. You're super chatting one card. Okay, we have a... it's a clue, first clue. It's like, is it like, it's the first clue ever discovered in the history of Magic the Gathering. Green 1 generic. Chapter 1, investigate. Chapter 2, put a shield counter on target creature you control. Target creature you control, fight a creature you don't control. And then chapter 3, target creature you control, explore. Draw a card. I love all of them. Nothing against any of those. Bacon cap. Oh, we did final offer. It was broken. Deuce exacted. Okay. This is 2 mana, instant. Counter target spell unless its controller pays its mana cost. Oh, that has to be fair. Like, you're spending, like, this is a weird conditional counter spell. This almost seems hilarious. You could just pay double blue to counter target spell, or you can splash white and, I don't know, torture your opponent into paying its mana cost again. You spent it. You paid 4 for that spell, but will you be willing to pay another 4? You like this a lot? It won't. You might not even counter the spell with this thing. It may not even be possible. I'm gonna try to counter your red spell for 1 mana. What about that lose the game spell? Or target player loses the game for one red. Won't stop that at all. It's like that enchantment in the Eye of Chaos. It's possible. Yeah, it will work for high CMC cards. This is a really underwhelming counter spell. It's funny though. David, what do you got for us? Who needs they lie brussy 8? The hell? The lie brussy. Who needs? How about who needs? I don't get it. Is this Nicolas Cage? Okay, who needs they lie brussy 8? It's a black Dimir, blue, 2 generic, curse. Enchant target opponent. Pay X, tap. Enchanted player mills X cards, where X is the number of times their commanders have entered the battlefield. Oh my god, me, says Gisa. I don't get it. So enchant opponent. Enchanted player mills X cards, where X is the number of times their commanders have entered the battlefield. Oh! So you want to punish people for playing their commander too many times. Is this supposed to be sussy? Sussy? Well, we're not done. I got super chats to go through. The show is done when it's done. Certainly not done yet. Nicholas Knee. You get to have it. All right. Next one, another. I edited part 2 so you can find it. Meanwhile, have the day. What is it? The day Leonora. Oh no, you keep using them special characters. The day L. The day Leonora disappeared. And again, thank you very much for the super chat. Okay, we have a blue, 3 generic. What the hell is this? 5 chapters? Chapter 1, exile a creature you control with 4 time counters on it. It gains suspend. All right, we got to put you on suspend, because you know what? I'm going to blow up the board here. Chapter 2, 3 and 4, investigate for each suspended cards you own in exile. The first time a land enters the battlefield under your control this turn, draw a card and create a map token. Why do we have so many abilities? So we investigate for each suspend card. It's probably going to be 1. And then chapter 5. Reveal the top 5 cards of your library. You may put a legendary card from among them onto the battlefield. Put the rest into your graveyard. That being said, I think this is okay. Because it is 5 mana. And it's really, really, really slow. And everything it does is like a little bit underwhelming. Forgot to edit the saga reminder in there. Oh, that it is a saga. Well, there's probably not enough room in here to explain what a saga is. If you know, you know. Okay, Bacon Catbug with Rallying Resolve. Infinite Money Glitch. This is my Infinite Money Glitch. Rallying Resolve. Okie dokie. So Boros instant, attacking creatures you control gain first strike until end of turn. So far so good. Blocking creatures you control gain double strike until end of turn. Aha! A great offense is a strong defense. And this defense is stronger than the offense, that's for sure. And finally we got Majra's, what's it called? Ain no Himitsu. no Himitsu. Thank you everyone who used the Discord today. Made this show smooth and easy. Black, blue, blue, white, arcane instant. Scry X, then gain X life. Where X is equal to the number of cards you own in exile. If X is 8 or more, draw 4 cards. Scry X, then gain X 8 life. Where X... Oh, so if you gain 8 or more life, you get to draw 4 cards. I think everything in exile... That actually would be really easy to pull off. Because it's like... what's it called? I actually think this is broken. So a combination of flashback or just the delve spells, you'll get like 8 cards in exile pretty easily. And then all of a sudden this is 4 mana draw 4, which is an insane rate. And you gain like an insane amount of life. But I guess you have to exile. If you don't exile the cards, it's crap. I don't know. I don't know where I am on this card. This card could be really strong. Or it could be really absolutely pathetic. They are the Delve colors, that's right. They are the Delve colors. Except for those of us who didn't put a title in our cards, that's right. Don't worry, well, it's better on the Discord than not on the Discord at all. And then Majra. One more for the road. Sir, to mind you, but could you review part 2 of the Eternity, please? Did we not do that? Part 2 of the Eternity. Do we not do it at all? Review part 2. Okay, hold on. Did we not do any of these? Okay, sorry. You probably... The thing is, sometimes I clear the super chat when I know I'm done with it. But then sometimes I forget. And because so many of your titles are the same, I probably cleared it thinking that we already did it already. All right. We've got a whole set to go through. The Eternal Duel, red, blue, instant, arcane. Target creature you control, fight. Target creature you don't control. If a creature dealt damage this way, dies this turn, you draw a card. It's a very unusual card to have, and is it, though? Eternal Embrace. It's a blue, blue, 2 generic. Kindred sorcery, arcane spirit. Cost 2 less to cast if you target a spirit. Create a token copy of target creature. It's a spirit in addition to its other types. You're trying to make, I don't know, some utility out. There's not a whole lot of spirits here. Like a spirit cards. Eternal Fan. It's a black 1 generic. It also reminds me of one of the Lotus cards. This looks beautiful. It's like some sort of Lotus. It looks like Jeweled Lotus to me. When it's a equipment spirit, which is a weird card type, but okay. When Eternal Fan enters the battlefield, attach it to target creature you control. Equipped creature is a warlock in addition to its other creature types and gets +2/+2 and has lifelink. Whenever equipped creature deals combat damage to a player, you may exile a card from any graveyard, then create a treasure token. Equipped for 3 mana. Oh, cool. Land. Eternal Garden. We can tap to add a Colossus, or we can add Grixis. One of Grixis. This mana can be only spent to cast spirits and or arcane spells and abilities. And it cannot even be searched up, so it is very fair. Eternal Kanushi. It's a red 1 generic 3/2 human spirit cleric wizard. With persist, whenever a spell or ability you control deals excess damage to a creature or planeswalker an opponent controls, it deals damage equal to the excess to the controller of that permanent. Doesn't that mean like it just has trample? Like we have planeswalker trample that exists, right? So now you can have like spell trample. Everything has spell trample around here. Spell trample. Oh, because I got skipped. I got stuck on part 1. I got stuck everywhere. This was a show to get stuck on. Okay, Eternal Kakai. It is a red-blue enchantment with flash and super parade. What that is, I have no idea. Enters the battlefield, deals 2 damage to any target. Exile it from your graveyard. Target arcane card in your graveyard gains flashback until end of turn. The flashback cost is equal to its mana cost. So it's like Snapcaster Mage, deal 2 damage. I guess the problem is how to get it into your graveyard. So it will be fine. Eternal Mantle. Is it black? Equipment spirit. Equipped creature gets +1/+0 for each arcane or spirit in your graveyard. Equip for 3. And equip spirit for 2. You get a little discount if you're a spirit. Ooh, I really like the art on this card. Dimir, 1 generic. Eternal Memories. Sorcery. It's also an arcane spell. Add target instant or sorcery from your graveyard to your hand. Exile Eternal Memories. Add target instant or sorcery from your graveyard to your hand. It's like regrowth. Exile Eternal Memories. As instant or sorcery. Cannot tell if danger or not. Add target. It's more like return it from your graveyard to your hand. You think it's fine? All right. I think it's like regrowth. Eternal Midnight Bloom. Black, blue, instant, arcane, draw a card. Then Eternal Midnight Bloom deals 1 damage to any target. Until end of turn, each instant and sorcery cards from your hand, graveyard, deck, and exile, and spells you control are arcane. And it also has flashback for 3 mana. That's a lot of value, actually. 1 damage ping. You like, basically, it's a 1 damage ping, but you also draw a card off of it. Then you can do it again, so it's like 2 draws in 1. It's really harsh against those little mana dork decks. And finally, I'm free. Oh my goodness, you people. People super chat like all day, all night. The infinite money glitch, go burr! And if you want to be part of that infinite money glitch, you got to be here weekdays, 11 o'clock a.m. Central Standard Time. Thanks everyone who supports the channel. If you're a patron on Patreon, a member on YouTube, you super chat to contribute your cards, and even the people who super chat to help other people get their cards contributed. And we also have got to thank the coffee crew for being here today. We got Palajam, Daniel. We got Holop Buildly, Daniel, Platonic Liquid, Majra, RJ, Steve Cooper. Where's Bacon Catbug? Bacon Catbug's here too. Vitron Espada for Ginky. Well, for Ginky, you stayed here to the end. Balder! People who stayed a whole 2.5 hours. You're the real heroes around here. And as usual, my coffee crew, you keep brewing up them coffees, and we will keep brewing up the magic. Take care of yourselves, and I will see you at the next cup.